game against the Sooners, of course, takes on a great deal of importance for us. I think a lot of the people in Nebraska have narrowed it down to almost a one-game season where you can do pretty well, but if you don't beat Oklahoma, you've had a bad year. So naturally, there's a lot of heat on us to win. But all we've really asked our players to do is to go out and play the very best they possibly can. And we're not too concerned about who we're playing today. We're trying to play against ourselves and see how well we can play. And we just hope we put on a great game for everybody that's watching and for the people in Nebraska particularly.
The comments of the head coaches of Oklahoma and Nebraska. College football today from Lincoln, Nebraska's Memorial Stadium. The Big Eight shootout between these two offensive giants, number one ranked Oklahoma against number four ranked Nebraska. This ABC Sports Exclusive is brought to you by Tuborg Gold. When you go for beer, go for the gold. Tuborg Gold. By the Continental Insurance Company. And by Remington XLR, the electric shaver that shaves as close as a blade. Look at these numbers. The national ranking in total offense, yards per game, Nebraska, better than 500. Oklahoma, better than 480. In scoring, Nebraska, 41 plus. Oklahoma, 40 plus. So it has to be an offensive show, you would think, this afternoon here in Lincoln. And hello again, everybody. I'm Keith Jackson. And having come from Las Vegas last night to Lincoln, Nebraska, I have found a 40-degree drop in the temperature. It is cold. The winter has gone south. I mean, the weather has gone south, or whatever it is. It's cold enough to make a brass monkey clink, I'll tell you that. And the wind is continuing to whip across the open countryside here and will definitely be a factor before the day is done. This will be the 99th consecutive sellout here at Memorial Stadium for University of Nebraska football. A remarkable record that goes all the way back to the second game of the 1962 season. Some of the factors surrounding this ball game. That's first place in the polls for one. There's the Big Eight Conference title for another. And the trip to the Orange Bowl, which could set up the possibility of a national championship game on New Year's night. There's also a thing called bragging rights out of this part of the country in this game between Oklahoma and Nebraska, and that has a great deal to do with recruiting. And underlying all of it is the simple fact that the Nebraska Cornhuskers have not beaten the Oklahoma Sooners since 1971, and that does not make your winter warm. The quarterback is Thomas Lott, but you see his average, you know he's carried the ball a lot. Sims at an even 1,400 yards, but look at the average per carry. King, the fullback, averaging just under 8 yards per carry.
King, of course, is a great fullback, and he was a halfback. All four of these backs weigh close to 200 pounds, and they can move with that football.
Let's look at the man who pulls the trigger for the Oklahoma offense. Number six, his name is Thomas Lott, and he is a very good one.
Barry Switzer says that Thomas Lott is the finest wishbone quarterback ever to play at Oklahoma. And here's the reason why. Barry says he can explode off of the fullback fake, and he's a strong enough runner to turn down the field and make yardage. Run through arms right here. Watch him explode outside the block, turn up the field with those powerful legs, and make yards. He is something to behold to see in this wishbone offense.
But the pass also becomes a very serious part of their arsenal.
When you defense the run, 9 out of 10 plays, you're vulnerable to the pass. On this particular play, Kimmel got in behind Texas for a touchdown.
Now, here's the man, number 20, Billy Sims.
Billy Sims, according to Barry Switzer, is the finest back he's seen in a long, long time. Look at the power in his legs. Barry says that this is his key. He's built himself up from 180 pounds to 205, working on weights, and it's just a mismatch. When he gets in the secondary, watch his quickness right up the middle. When he goes into that secondary, a poor defensive back, one-on-one, has no chance. 4.5 speed, 205 pounds, a great player.
But you don't get in too involved with Billy Sims, because this fella, Kenny King, will break your back.
The first option of the wishbone is the handoff to the fullback. One missed tackle, 9.6 speed, and Kenny King, and watch out as he did here on this play against the University of Texas.
But you get preoccupied with the three we've shown you, and here's a big sophomore, David Overstreet, that has plenty of tools, too.
Overstreet, 4'4", 192 pounds, and watch this young sophomore use his blocking of Billy Sims, who Barry says is also a great blocker. When he doesn't have the football, a good player. But Sims knows how to run. Overstreet gained 7,000 yards in high school.
So those are the four backs that operate behind this big Oklahoma offensive front, and there are all kinds of people playing up in the offensive front who at one time or another were involved in the 40-yard sprints themselves, 250, 60-pounders who knocked down a 4-7. About the defense now. People have said the one weakness of this Oklahoma team might lie within the defense, but that's a hard sell to me because you're looking right up the middle at three All-Americans. Nose guard Reggie Kinlaw and two linebackers, George Cumbie and Darrell Hunt. And this fella, Kinlaw, is a horse.
Kinlaw makes tackles all over the field. He's really a linebacker playing nose guard. He was a great one in high school, but he makes All-American because he is can roam the football field. He can make tackles on all sides of the field. And this is what Barry said worries him, because he's afraid that they will hammer the ball right at these three All-Americans. How unrealistic can he be?
It is oftentimes said that a college football team, to a large degree, reflects the character, the temperament, the personality of the coach. This Oklahoma team is a loose football team. They frolicked through the Friday afternoon drills yesterday. In fact, there were no drills. But it's a team that is well prepared, and it's a team put together by the next young man, Bill Fleming, talks to Barry Switzer.
Coach, how do you evaluate this team, the 1978 Sooners, with the others that you've had coming into this Nebraska game?
I think we're a good football team, Bill. I think it's certainly one of our best we've had offensively. We were more talented than we probably were in 1971. We had all the great stats that year. But the one area I'm concerned with is the defense. We can run very well, but we're not physical. We're not a great physical team that when we had the Selman brothers and quite a few of the other superstars we had in the early 70s.
Thanks very much for joining us, and the best of luck to you, Barry. In just a moment, then, we'll be back as Keith and Frank take a look at this Nebraska team.
This is what's left of an antique pitcher from a home insured by Continental. Our policyholder thought he could figure out how much he lost right away. But Continental knows that troubled people forget items like this. We'd rather have our clients take the time to file a complete claim and not rush into a settlement that's too small. If you want fair protection like that, remember, nobody spells protection like the Continental Insurance Companies.
Go for the gold. Danish heritage of American blood.
Oklahoma against number four ranked Nebraska from Lincoln today. And now a look at the Cornhuskers, Frank Royals. To me, the offense of Nebraska under Tom Osborne has always been one of the most imaginative. The one exception I would suggest would have been the opening game this year against Alabama, in which the Crimson Tide just shut them down completely in Birmingham. But also, obviously, there have been some rather dramatic changes made.
I think the biggest change has been the development of the offensive line. This type of offense, the I formation, is a slow developing. You have to have big offensive linemen that can sustain and maintain their blocks, and that has been true in the last few ball games. Also, Keith, and we talked about this, the prominent role of their wingback, Kenny Brown, not only as a pass receiver, but as a ball carrier. This gives them the misdirection that the I formation is historically famous for. And then their tight end, Junior Miller, number 89, who has second leading receiver in the Big Eight, has caught 25 passes for over 20 yards. This is the man that they hope that can keep the linebackers of Oklahoma honest playing football.
What you're telling me now is the guys who play the offensive position in the trenches, you want them to be patient as well as anonymous, huh?
They said, I don't know about that, but when you look at them, as I did yesterday, they look great. They are impressive.
All right, let's look at some of these people we're talking about. Start with the quarterback, Tom Sorley, who has developed into a very poised performer for these Cornhuskers, and we'll see him first as he goes to the pass to Kenny Brown, that wingback.
Sorley has developed into an acceptable pass. On this particular play-action pass, Kenny Brown gets in behind the secondary for the touchdown. He can throw deep. That's important in setting your offensive plan. He also can throw quick, as he does on this pass, to Junior Miller, the big tight end, the fine target. You can see he's a good runner after he catches the football. Now, the wind will be some factor in this ball game, Keith, as we mentioned earlier. Then the screen pass to Kenny Brown is a very prominent part of their offense. They believe in screens, a slip screen and all, to keep the defense from rushing all the time.
Runners, there are plenty of those at Nebraska, too. Big guys like Rick Burns, who is, I think, one of the underrated backs in this part of the country. He's a big, strong fellow, and he's backed up by number 32, I.M. Hip.
Rick Burns is a fine football player, very tough. But here you can see that on the first play, he ran outside, which is a little bit unusual. Then we see I am hit, number 32, who has developed himself into a good inside runner. Big and strong, worked on the weight. You can see the strength of his legs also, Keith. The big thighs are really an indication of how good a runner can be. He's a good one.
The wingback reverse, also a basic play in Tom Osborne's book.
Trickery is part of Tom's offense. Here, this may be a big play, a wingback reverse such as this, because Oklahoma has the speed to pursue so quickly they need to be kept at home.
That was one of the plays, if you go back to that opening game and opening telecast, that was missing in the game against Alabama. Didn't run it one single time, but I'll guarantee you they will before the game's over today. The defense, now we've talked about all these big horses coming flying out of the Oklahoma backfield. We also have to consider the Nebraska defensive positions by position. Now you take the middle of the defensive front for Nebraska. It is led by number 51, Kerry Winemaster, who weighs only 216 pounds.
Kerry Winemaster is very concerned about his role today, knowing that you must stop the wishbone, the first phase, a fullback up the middle. And he's not sure that he can do it. But also, the coaches are concerned, Keith, about the defensive secondary. The secondary have a vital, critical role in supporting these wishbone plays. They're more like linebackers, and they're not very physical. They're small for the backs that we see in football today.
Point being amplified, I think, by the fact that Fisher, a cornerback, comes in at 165 pounds, and their rover, or monster man, Pillen, weighs only 183 pounds. They've got to be taking on running backs that weigh over 200 and who can really, truly fly. But there's a thing called emotion, the human factor. These Nebraska players have never beaten an Oklahoma football team. The last time Nebraska beat the Sooners in 1971. The players obviously feel strongly about this, which is why we turn to them for their reaction on the eve of this big game.
This game is probably the most meaningful game to myself and probably the rest of the players on the team. It's been since 1971, since we beat Oklahoma. That was in our national championship year. We feel this is a year that we can't accomplish it. Our goal is to win the Big Eight this year, and we feel that if we win this game, we will, and it will enable us to go to the Orange Bowl, which is in Miami, which has been a team goal.
I think that this Oklahoma game, you know, it means an awful lot to us because there's so much at stake, but it's been that way every year, and we're just going to go out and play as hard as we can and get rid of this so-called jinx what people are saying that Oklahoma has over us and prove to people just what kind of football team we do have.
We felt like that it would probably come down to a shootout with Oklahoma, and sure enough, that's what it's come down to, and we just feel like that if we execute properly that we'll win the game and we'll win the Big Eight Championship, and a lot of our goals and a lot of our dreams will be fulfilled.
We're going to play Oklahoma, and we're going to beat them, and we're going to just go right on and play Missouri, and we're going to win the national championship. And then now I can go and when I go home to Texas, I can speed through Oklahoma and get a ticket and show them my Nebraska license.
Why did I go too fast? The players and their opinion. But how about Tom Osborne, the man who has coached here for 6 years, who has taken his teams to a bowl game every year, but he has never knocked down the Sooners, says this to Bill Fleming.
Coach, how would you rate this 1978 Nebraska team with the other teams that you've had here?
Well, I don't know, Bill. It's a little hard to say until you've really completed the season. But I would say that, for the last 8 games, we've probably played on a par with some of our very best teams. We've moved the ball through that 8 or 9 game period better than any team we've ever had. I think we're averaging 515-some yards per game, which is the most that I can ever remember that we've averaged. And I think our defense is better. And yet it's still a little bit of a puzzle because we didn't play that well against Alabama, and then we've come back and played real good football. But, you know, to pass verdict on a team until you've played Oklahoma and Missouri and possibly a bowl is a little premature.
Is there any mystique at all, any jinx factor involving Oklahoma? So many times, you know, you've been very optimistic going into this game against the Sooners and come up dry.
Well, I don't know. I think probably the biggest jinx they've had is just they've had great football teams. You know, they've over the last 7 or 8 years, they've won 80-some and lost only 7 or 8. And so even though we have not been very successful at beating them, nobody else has either. And they've had some great athletes. You can talk about luck or jinx or whatever you want, but I'm afraid that you have to just say that maybe it's been more of an ability factor than anything else. And we've had 1 or 2 games where they've had some good fortune, but they've also had the great athletes to bring it off. They've had the speed. And whereas some of the plays that have turned into 40, 50-yard gains for them with their athletes might have been 10-yard gains with somebody else's athletes. So they're a very talented football team. And I would say that this year Oklahoma is probably the best offensive team I've ever seen them have. And defensively, they're very much on a par with some of their better teams.
Okay, Coach, thanks very much for joining us. The best of luck. Now let's go back to Keith Jackson for more of the pregame activity here on the field.
Thank you, Bill, and always bottom lines out at that, doesn't it? People and ability. Right now, we're going to join the University of Nebraska band here on windswept Cole Memorial Stadium for our national anthem. Shootout. This exciting football game between the top two offensive teams in the nation, Nebraska and Oklahoma. The band marching off the field, and I think you can look at some of the faces as they play the national anthem to give you an idea of just how cold it is. The temperature is in the low 30s and headed down, and they're even talking about a little snow, maybe, before the day is done. But winter has arrived in Lincoln, Nebraska. But everywhere you look this afternoon, it is red. The colors of the Sooners, of course, very much involving red. And you walk down the streets of Lincoln and yell, "Go Big Red, you're safe." Because I don't know who you're talking about. As long as you don't say Sooners or Huskers, then if you get that definite about it, you can get somebody after you. But it is a festive afternoon as we get ready for the very important Big 8 conference game, the important game nationally between Nebraska and NCAA football. Today from Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska, Oklahoma and Nebraska. The Swift Sooners will be led by the great Billy Sims. Nebraska led by their tough running back, Rick Burns. And this ABC Sports Exclusive is brought to you by the folks at Chevrolet, who invite you to come on in to your Chevy dealers coast to coast for a look at an all-star lineup of cars. By Kodak, whose new Kodak Ectralite 10 camera with built-in flash says, "Open me first to save Christmas in pictures." And by Fran, makers of oil, air, and fuel filters, windshield wipers, and Autolite spark plugs. This is what college football is all about, when you can get a couple of teams with those kind of numbers matched up close to the end of a season, with so much more to come for each of them if there is to be success. Oklahoma, first in both the major polls. Nebraska, fourth in both the major polls. And over the last 6 years, there's all kinds of numbers you can play with as the Sooners wearing white come into the stadium. And you look at Oklahoma's record, you can see that only two teams really gave them a lot of trouble. The opener, Stanford, when Stanford had the ball in the end zone as the gun went off, a possible winner. After the Texas game, the Sooners were sore and beat up, and Kansas almost got them as Oklahoma pulled it out by a single point. But since that time, they have not been breathing very hard. The University of Nebraska Cornhuskers playing here at home, and when they start out of the tunnel, I think you will hear the whole middle of the country rattle a little bit because here they come, and here's the sound. Record for the Huskers, their only loss in the opening game in Birmingham to Alabama by a score of 20-3. But since that time, they've gone on to lead the nation in offense and in scoring. And they ran off 63 points against Cripple Kansas last week. Part of the reasoning for that 63 explained in Tom Osborne's comment that he could take only 54 players, and he played everybody he had, but he couldn't hold it down. So that's where we are. The big one. The shootout, they call it in this part of the country between the Huskers and the Sooners. I'm Keith Jackson along with Frank Royals. Let's talk briefly about the weather, Frank. It is cold at about 34, 35 degrees and going down. The wind is blowing 16 to 25 miles an hour.
Yesterday, both coaches said they would prefer ideal weather conditions so that they wouldn't have this handicap. But the weather does affect certain phases of the game, particularly the putting part of the game and the field goal. It will reduce the range of the field goal kickers by at least 20 yards. And Keith, if you're punting into the wind, this 25 mile an hour wind, and you don't get a sparrow, you might catch your own punt.
Plus the fact the ball gets hard. I don't care what you say. The confounded football gets hard when it's cold like this.
Well, Barry Switzer said that the wet field would hamper him more. And, of course, Osmond said the wind would, because it does affect the passing game more. And the reason is that the passing coaches have been known, Keith, to kind of deflate the ball a little bit, because it gives you a little bit better touch. Well, today's football is going to be hard. It's going to be slick. The hand is going to be cold. And when they throw that ball, it has a tendency to sail. So it could be a major factor in this ball game.
But everywhere you look, the colors are red, as we mentioned, and the enthusiasm and the fervor for this ball game all across the country is enormous, because these are, for a fact, two outstanding football teams. We're going to sick them in just a minute.
Right now is a great time for love. Chevy Love Series 8 with a 7.5-foot box, the longest box of any economy-sized pickup, with soft ride suspension, with a 1,635-pound payload capacity, and the kind of mileage you might expect. 34 miles per gallon on the highway, 24 city. See your Chevy.
Last 6 years, you can see the last time the Huskers won was 35-31 in the game of the century, as they defined it then, down in Norman. And the overall series record. There is another startling thing that absolutely floors you when you look back at the last 6 years and look at the final quarter of play. Since 1971, the Nebraska Cornhuskers have not scored a single point in the final quarter. Oklahoma has scored 79 points over those years in the final quarter. That's just startling to me. A ball club that is always gifted and as imaginative as Nebraska could not score in the final quarter. But then Oklahoma is a little bit different than a lot of football teams around the country, aren't they?
Yes, they are, Keith. Very definitely. The wishbone makes those adjustments of the various blocking schemes during the ball game. And by the time the fourth quarter comes around, they know your scheme, your tendencies, and they can take advantage of it.
Those are the officials for today's game, and they are veteran Big 8 officials. Have done many ball games with all of them, led by the referee Earl Schustrom, and they are an outstanding group of officials. So the two teams are now on the field. Oklahoma wearing the white, Nebraska in the home red. Kenny Brown and Frank Lockett will be the deep men to receive the kickoff. The Huskers winning the toss and Oklahoma taking the win. So I would think that Uwe von Schaumann will probably just kick it on up into the stands if he gets it up into a wind that is gusting up as high as 25 miles an hour. Von Schaumann comes into this ball game 7 out of 10 in field goals this year, but he's run off 115 consecutive extra points. So he's already put his name in the NCAA record book and apparently is not finished yet. Young man who was born in Germany but who grew up in Fort Worth, Texas. I don't think I shall ever forget last year in the Ohio State ball game, when first I was amused by the two kickers in that game, Ane Vodakievsky and Uwe von Schaumann. But it was von Schaumann who won it under a tremendous amount of pressure. And here he is in one more big game today, and the ball is in the air. High and hanging, and here's a return. by Lockett, who gets past the 20. My goodness, if he had been able to get just beyond the 25-yard line, he could have run for a week. Jay Jemerson brought him down. It is Tom Sorley opening at quarterback, a senior. Rick Burns, another Texan, another senior at the I back. Andrew Franklin, the sophomore out of Anniston, Alabama, at fullback. Kenny Brown out of Cincinnati is the wingback, and Smith is the split in. We had Von Schaumann decked on the kickoff, and he was flat of his back, but he rolled up and came off the field all right. And we have another Sooner down on the field. It looks like it's Freddie Nixon, number 11, who is the backup man to Billy Sims at the left halfback position. And Freddie Nixon also oftentimes involved in returning kicks. So Nixon is down for a long time. Von Schaumann was decked. And I would say this, Frank, that neither one of these teams are deep enough to lose very many of their front liners very early in the ball game. You see Nixon, number 11, coming in here to make the play on the ball carrier, and he literally ran into his own man and deflated him. But he's all right now. He ran into Jay Jemerson. Here's the first offensive play of the ball game. First down, Nebraska, from their own 24-yard line. A capacity crowd. And the play being called at the line of scrimmage for Andrew Franklin, the fullback. He's out to the 27, and he picks up 3 yards. The offensive front for the University of Nebraska: Kelvin Clark, he's a big guy, 275. Barney Cotton, 245 at guard. Kelly Saulfield, 237 center. Steve Lindquist, a 250-pounder at guard. Tim Ort, a 244-pound tackle. And Junior Miller, who's in at 222. Second down and 7 for the Huskers from their 27. Oklahoma's got a 6-man front up there looking at him right now. The pitch goes to Rick Burns on the sweep. He cuts it back to the 30, breaks loose to the 32. They'll mark him, I guess, just short of the 32, but that's a good, tough, determined run by a good, tough back.
He turned up inside beautifully after the Oklahoma pursuit forced him back inside for a nice game.
Defensive front for Oklahoma: Mathis, Goodman, Kinlaw, Tabor, and Tayton. The linebackers are Cumby and Hunt, and the secondary, Banks, Jimerson, Babb, and Ray. Third down and 3 for Nebraska. They send Kenny Brown, the wingback, in motion, give it a Burns to the tight side of the field, all the way, no how, as Reggie Mathis, number 58, read that play from the very beginning, held his position, and then when the play came to him, he was right there to do it.
He got off of the best blocking tight end I think the Big Eight had, Junior Miller. He released and went right out the line. Instead of cutting back, the tailback went outside for no gain.
And now, as Nixon is back in the ball game, having been shaken up on the kickoff to return the punt, Smith has got to kick the ball into a 20-mile-an-hour wind. And Oklahoma figures to get good field position, so Smith hangs it up there pretty well, and a fair catch is made by Basil Banks, number 17, and the Oklahoma Sooners get the ball at their 38-yard line. Thomas Lott will open at quarterback, the senior out of San Antonio. Billy Sims will open at the halfback, a junior out of Hooks, Texas. From Big Sandy comes David Overstreet, and Kenny King is from Clarendon. All Texans, and then there's a Californian that split in, Bobby Kimball from Camarillo. First down Sooners at their own 38-yard line, out of the wishbone. And the Huskers bore in and get locked behind the line of scrimmage.
How about that, Keith? Penetration on the first play. That destroys the offense of the wishbone.
Obrey opens at tackle. Tabor is at guard for Oklahoma. Farthing is playing center for the Sooners. Greg Roberts, one of the really good ones in the country. He's a Texan. Sam Clappin out of Stillwell, Oklahoma, at tackle. And Big Victor Hicks is at the tight end. Second down and 13. The movement is out to the 40 with Billy Sims, who's at 205 pounds carrying the ball. And so it brings up now third down and 8. Defensively for Nebraska, Lawrence Cole and George Andrews the ends. Horn and Pinsick the tackles, and Winemasters in the middle. The linebackers are Dunning and Coons. The secondary, Fisher, Means, Hanson, Pillen. Steve Rhodes is back in the game. First game since Texas. And Thomas Lott will put it up, looks for Rhodes, throws, and can't hold on. That's what I meant about the ball being hard. On a hot, warm, sticky day, he might have picked it off the turf.
It was a very simple pass to hit, one that Lott has had good consistency with, but Keith, the ball did sail. It went too far to the left, incomplete.
And so the Sooners are unsuccessful in their first offensive possession. And in eight of their nine games this year, Oklahoma has put a point on the board either in their first or second possession. Now the punt. Daryl Ray, defensive back, does the kicking.
Ground and lock it. Deep back for draft.
Hangs it up in the wind. It's not a very long kick, and it takes a Nebraska bounce and the spin dead at about the 25-yard line. With 11:51 to go in the first quarter, Nebraska gets the ball for the second time, and there is no score. Tom Osborne, a man who has not beaten Oklahoma in the 6 years he's been here as the head coach. The Huskers have the ball, first down at their own 25. The same unit lines up offensively as we had in the first series, with Sorley handing the ball to Andrew Franklin, the fullback. Franklin, an Alabama, goes all the way out to the 35. He is very close to a first down before Daryl Ray and Basil Banks can gang up on him.
Keith, that's just second effort with Franklin on a straight handoff. He cuts back out there after getting a little penetration in the second. Watch him, just second effort right away from Kinlaw, and finally Mathis brings him down.
It is second down, less than a yard for the first down for Nebraska. Will they gamble here? The Sooners are in tight. Nope, they'll not put it up. They give it a rich turn. Hammers over the left side. He's down. That fumble. Nope. He was well down before the ball came loose. Reggie Mathis brought him down. And watch the work in the line by the Nebraska offensive people against the Oklahoma nose guard, Kinlaw.
The center and left guard, Keith, are going to double-team Kinlaw. He merits double-team. And watch Franklin take on Humphrey and the determined running effort by Byrne.
First down, Nebraska at the 42. Franklin again. This time they stack him.
Ball carried by
42
Franklin.
To the 44, where Mathis and Goodman make the tackle for Oklahoma. And Goodman, a junior out of Garland, Texas, has been playing very well defensively for the Sooners. He's moved right up behind Kinlaw as the leading tackler.
Second down, eight.
Four straight runs right up the middle, which Barry said he was afraid of this. His team is not as physical. Inside is the Nebraska offensive line.
Well, you thought he was putting you on.
I did.
Second down at eight. Here's the wing back reverse inside to Kenny Brown. Kinlaw stayed home in the middle and got him. If Reggie is not there, Brown might have broken it.
Watch Reggie Kinlaw. His assignment over the offensive center is just control him and find the football. He actually is up above the blocker where he can see the reverse play, and he rolls right back in for a great play.
And it is third and long now from the 45. Third and seven. Lockett is in at a wide position. First pass of the ball game from Sorley. He goes short. That should get a flag. Nope. It does not get a flag, as Darrell Hunt ran into Rick Burns and knocked him flat, and the ball was thrown right to him.
Well, if we look at the replay, I think you'll see that it was interference. It's a short delay play after the linebackers dropped deep right over the line of scrimmage. You watch Hunt collision in before the ball got there. No wonder the Nebraska fans are booing.
But in the judgment of the official, the pass perhaps they thought might have been thrown at Junior Miller. Whatever it is, fourth down. Tim Smith is in to kick. Hits the end over ender to Nixon. And Nixon, trying to come back with it, gets a little bit out of it as he comes just short of the 30-yard line after a 31-yard punt into a 20-mile-an-hour wind. 9:37 to play. First quarter, no score.
Hey, Mr. Goodrem.
Let's go back to that pass play. Sorley trying to throw the ball. From here, it looks like Burns. And as we look at the replay, it looks like Burns. He's flattened by Hunt. But then you see Miller curling back there. Perhaps from their perspective, the official thought it pass intended for Miller. Don't know, but whatever. It's Oklahoma the ball at the 30-yard line. And in their second possession, it is Billy Sims just ripping and, no, it is Kenny King ripping and tearing holes in that Nebraska defense. And he goes for 17 yards all the way out to the 47-yard line.
Keith, I believe that's the most determined run that I've seen by Kenny King any time this year. He went right through would-be tacklers at the line in the secondary and just kept moving down the field.
King, Sims, and Overstreet, and King is in motion now. The ball is given to Billy Sims, who is the leading runner in the country, and he is hammered right about the line of scrimmage, maybe 1 yard. So it'll be second down nine for the Sooners.
George Andrews in on the plate. Keith, all the way from defensive end up to the play up in the inside over the center.
He is
great effort on
an outstanding football player.
He is a key in this ball game. Will be.
It's a six-man front for Nebraska. As Lott rides it outside to Billy Sim. And that little number 48, Jeff Hansen it is, comes up. He's not so little at that, is he? 198 pounds. Tim Fisher, number 16, back there, is only at 165 pounds. But over the years, Nebraska seemingly has always had one or two little guys back there who were really tough. But that play is good for yardage all the way inside the Nebraska 45.
Keith, the free safety has got to be a critical man in the defensive plans for Nebraska.
Third down and one, Sim. Your first down and then some. Breaks one 44 yards. And he may very well put his name in the record books before the day's done. He's gone for 203 consecutive games, and Von Schaumann drills it way up into the stand. 116 consecutive extra points now by Von Schaumann. With 8:09 to go in the first quarter, we look at the touchdown run by Billy Sims one more time.
Look, Keith, it was short yardage, and the safety man, 48, Hansen, missed him in the line of scrimmage. But look at the strength of his legs as he just goes through those mismatched defensive backs. He's much stronger than them, and it turns on the speed for the touchdown.
Three Huskers had their hands on him, three of them, and includes one George Andrews, who's a big, strong defensive end, as good a defensive player as you'd want.
225 pounds, and the referee got in his way just a little bit. I believe the referee prevented Andrews from making the play, but Sims, watch it right here again. Andrews, 225 pounds, can't quite get it. The ref got in his way. Good block by the ref. So what a run that was.
And it's 7-0, 70 yards, four plays, took a minute and 28 seconds. Kenny Brown and Frank Lockett will be the deep men now for the Nebraska Cornhuskers as Von Schaumann puts it on the tee. And Oklahoma is working with the wind here in the first quarter.
That was Switzer's plan. He wanted to win the first quarter where he could have field position, scoring opportunities, and score first in this big game.
Kicks in the air. Up to about the 23-yard line, where he's brought down by Gary Lowell. Bill Fleming will be with you at halftime. Bill will also be bringing you up to date on scores as they come in. And the temperature is settling. It's a night for the far in Lincoln, Nebraska. Billy Sim. Here are the Huskers now. They trail by seven from the 23-yard line. Rick Byrne. Barrel 185 hits him high. But there's somebody underneath the stack that really locked his legs, and it's John Goodman, number 72. Following our game from Lincoln today between the Sooners and Cornhuskers, second half of the doubleheader, and those are the games in the areas of the country where you will see them. And many of them will have a good deal of meaning into the ultimate fortunes of the teams involved for 1978. Second down and two. It's Burns again, and Rick Burns, one of the more underrated running backs, I believe, in the country. He is really a fine running back. Jemison is out of the lineup now for Oklahoma, and Richard Turner has gone in there. They've pretty much put into what amounts to a goal line defense.
They go to the eight-man front, two linebacker, three deep when they feel like Nebraska's running right up the middle.
But the Huskers blew him out, get a first down at their own 36-yard line. Andrew Franklin, the big fullback. And Franklin pounds his way to the 41.
The strength of the offensive line is now coming into effect. Watch number 85, Darrell Hunt, All-American, 120 tackles already this year, has to take on the block of the fullback normally right there and then get off the fullback and make the tackle on Burns, number 39. Franklin, I'm sorry.
Second down and five from the 41 for Nebraska. Burns on an option. Missed the man. He threw for Miller, but he had Brown wide open. Brown was out there all by himself. Mike Babb, the strong safety, had dropped back to cover Brown, and he was a good 7, 8, maybe 10 yards from him.
Running pass is still the most difficult play to defend in football, particularly with a back like Burns throwing.
One of these days, somebody's going to come out with a couple of old-fashioned single-wing plays.
Quick kick.
Third down, five. Burns in motion. This time, Shorley will throw it. He shoots it for Junior Miller. Intercepted! George Cumbie, the linebacker, gets the football. He was off Miller's hands, and Cumbie was right there to catch it.
Cold hands, Keith, we talked about effects of the passing. Watch Miller, a little quick pass in front of the cornerback. Goes right through his hands. He took his eyes off it, but the ever alert George Cumbie, All-American, picks it up, a former fullback, protects that football, gets down on the ground, and gives the offense a chance. Here's another view, just a little quick pass outside the linebacker for the cornerback. Good alert effort on Cumbie's part.
First down shooters at their own 47-yard line. Thomas Lott keeps it to the 50. Lawrence Cole, defensive end, number 81, made the stop.
Second down.
Come on, D, come
what
on,
color bandana is George Thomas Lott wearing today? He's got a collection. People sending him bandanas from all over the country. Wears underneath his helmet. On second down and seven, it's Billy Sims again. And he's down to the Nebraska 44-yard line. Greg Roberts, a big right guard, pulled out and led him. He's now picked up 64 yards on five carries.
They went to the I formation on that particular down so that they could be assured of getting the ball to the great Billy Sims, the pitch sweep right out behind the good block of Hicks, the tight end, and Roberts, the guard.
Back into the wishbone this time on third down, and they need two. Block keeps it, now back to Sims. And Sims gets the two before Jeff Hansen, the safety man, comes up to make the tackle. And again, that safety man, as Frank pointed out a while ago, has to be a very important figure in the defensive play of Nebraska today against this Oklahoma team.
Keith, he takes his key from the tight end. If the tight end blocks, he tells himself, I'm a linebacker, and I must support the play at the line of scrimmage, hoping that the tight end doesn't block and then release.
Well, Victor Hicks is always blocking. Big as he is, he should. 250 pounds. This time, Overstreet, penalty flag. First one we've seen today is thrown at the line of scrimmage.
Overstreet, a penalty flag on the play.
On the first down play, the gain was good for about five from the 40, outside the 41, but the penalty is against Oklahoma. Somebody grabbed somebody and held on, and it'll cost them 15.
You know, the after effects of a penalty against the wishbone like this takes you somewhat out of your game plan. You have to run a little more high-risk offensive plays. At the same time, the defense are ready for it, Keith, so the defense now has the percentage in their favor.
The ball is moved just back inside the Oklahoma 45-yard line. They play on the artificial surface here at Lincoln. Pitches wide outside to Overstreet. Gets away from one Nebraskan. Finally, he is shoved out of bounds by Jeff Hansen. Andy Means was back there. Couldn't quite get him.
There again is the strength of those Oklahoma running backs, the blazing speed, the explosiveness, and yet they are strong enough to just use the stiff arm. Something we don't see very much anymore.
Those are the scoring quarter totals. You can see the Sooners have put a lot of points on the board in the first quarter. They lead here 7-0 with 4:54 to play in the first period. Second down, long. They've got to go to the Nebraska, inside the Nebraska 32 for their first down. Lott keeps it up the middle. And he is chucked down at the Oklahoma 49 by Bill Barnett, a defensive tackle out of Afton, Minnesota. That was Sooner touchdown coming on a 44-yard dart by Billy Sims.
Keith, that was a triple option trying to set up with a flare back, something unusual for Oklahoma this time of the year. They were trying to get the pitch to Sims, but Nebraska in would not let it happen.
The football is sitting at the 49-yard line of Oklahoma. They need, on third down, just about 17 yards. With Bobby Kimball wide to the right, Sims in motion, Lott back to throw. He runs out of time. Fumble. Sooners cover it. Jody Farthing, the center, covered the ball right about the line of scrimmage. There were two Huskers there, but they could not get to it.
Pass protection is the one thing on long yardage, obvious passing downs, that the Wishbone has trouble with because they work on the run. They throw the ball, the run the plays 9 out of 10 times, but you see what Lott can, how he can improvise, but somebody knocked that ball loose, but ever alert, Oklahoma got it back.
So it is fourth down. Darrell Ray is in the kick. This time he kicks with his shoe on, took it off, kicked in his stocking feet the last time. A fair catch is called. Back at the, well, let's call it the 12-yard line after a 34-yard punt. 7-0, Oklahoma. Tomorrow night, Sunday night, here on ABC, a couple of, as we call these last night, heavyweights in Nebraska. Well, you've got a couple of NFL heavyweights, the Steelers and the Rams, to go at it at 9 Eastern time here on ABC. Tomorrow night, Sunday night. We'll also have a game Monday night. Here's the pitch to Rick Burns. Fumble! Uh-oh. There is the one thing that terrifies you. You're back in that area of the field where you must be careful. The hard hit put on by Basil Banks. John Goodman. The ball comes loose from Burns, and Oklahoma covers it just inside the Cornhusker 14-yard line. It was Goodman that knocked it loose.
Burns is cutting back inside on the sweep play. When he turns back, he should protect the ball. Number 74, Goodman, knocks it right loose. A big break for Oklahoma.
Banks covered it, and just short of the 13, or inside the 14, it's first down Sooners. They lead 7-0, and the handoff to Kenny King. He's close to the 10. George Andrews and Bruce Dunning, defensive end and linebacker, make the stop.
Key football players on defense against the Wishbone, the linebackers and the defensive ends have to get involved in most every play. Otherwise, it's downtown.
3 minutes to go in the first quarter. The Sooners have the ball just short of the 10, second down. Nebraska's turned it over to the Sooners. One time already, and that was the second time. And here's Billy Sims. They had him way back upfield, and look where he wound up. Sims was all the way back at the 17-yard line where number 29, Jim Pillen, had a shot at him and couldn't bring him down.
That's with the mismatch we talked about is the quick pitch out of the I formation. Sims is, has to be forced outside. He'd like to cut back, watch Pillen, try to make the play. First, Andrews, 96, can't get him down. 16, coming up, try to help. Watch the power in his legs right here.
It is third down at the 11. Lott has it. Fumble. Nebraska gets it back. So the Huskers hold the Sooners as Jeff Henson covers the ball for Nebraska. Lee Kuntz, number 38, the senior out of Golden, Colorado, cupped him and the ball came loose. Leather football, when it's cold, gets slick.
It's hard to hold. Watch it. It's a counter option, but if you'll watch Lott, he does not put the ball away. He's carrying it with one hand. Look at it on his left hand. The Oklahoma, the only team, Keith, that let you get away with that, but they have such ability they can.
Nebraska now from the 7-yard line. Gives it to Ian Hip in the ball game for the first time, and he breaks it out for a first down. With 2:25 to go in the first quarter, If Nebraska can pick up a couple of first downs and move the ball out here, then the quarter's going to end and they'll get the win.
And they would be fortunate not to be more behind than a 7-0. The after effects of a fumble, there we see Ian Hip coming out, bruised his ankle, did a little bit of turn, twisted it just on that last play.
First down at the 18-yard line for Nebraska. Give it to the fullback, Franklin. Boy, did he take a wallop. It looked to me like the ball came loose that time, but Nebraska keeps it. Reggie Mathis and Darrell Hunt. It was Mathis that really sucked it to him.
Keith.
So you see the Huskers trying to hold on to the ball and keep possession so they can turn it around and go the other way. You can see how much the wind is blowing, about 20 miles an hour. Second down, good run there by the fullback Franklin, second and 5. Rick Mearn won't get much as Kinlaw penetrated, number 62. There's Lee Kuntz, the man that knocked the ball loose and caused the turnover, giving Nebraska possession.
Keith, you get a little momentum, you think you're going to have the second touchdown. But meantime, let's watch Kinlaw on the replay. Number 62, All-American nose guard. He wasn't double-teamed, Keith, like he was the previous time.
It is now third down and 4. Thorless pass. Good to lock it. First down, penalty flag. Going to get a face mask, I think, and that'll tack on 15. Basil Banks was over there.
Keith, it was pass interference. They'll take the play, but that was a daring call. I give, take my hat off to Tom Osmond. That is a dangerous play to be throwing right there.
I thought somebody had the face mask there for a minute, but I guess not. Just interference.
It's a throwback with a cornerback playing man for man right close to him. It could have been intercepted, but a great call by Tom Osmond.
So that gives Nebraska a first down out at the 34, and now only a minute left to play in the first quarter, and the Huskers will have the wind at their back. They only trail by 7, and I say that because they're the top scoring team in the country. Rick Burns with a good surge by the right side of the offensive line gets another big gain. That's Saulfeld, Lindquist, and Ort doing the work on the right side.
They are very, very impressive, and so is their fullback, Franklin, Keith. On these plays, he's nothing but a blocking back, and he's doing a great job.
That was a gain of 5 more yards out to the 39. Kenny Brown comes to the open side of the field for the Huskers. Rick Mearn leads it well. Penalty flags are down. You may have a clip. Burns went all the way to the 50 with 23 seconds showing on the clock.
Keith, Kinlaw is down on the ground. I'm not sure. There he is. Maybe it's just the breath knocked out.
It's going to be a holding call against Nebraska, so that's going to nullify that big gain by Rick Burns. But what a hold he had over the left side. That's Kelvin Clark and Barney Cotton's side of the line. They're 275 and 245, and one of the big moves that was made in the Nebraska offensive front was moving Barney Cotton into a guard position, and he's responded very well. There you see the Reggie Kinlaw down on the field, and he played last year with cartilage damage in his leg, but he refused the knife, said, "No, sir, I'll work it out." And in this instance, though, it looks to me like he was just had the wind knocked out of him.
Watch number 62, Kinlaw. Let's see what happens. He just got chopped. You can see it looks like the son of just chopped him there. And then falls on, then I guess the right tackle, or it falls on, yes, number 74.
Johnny Not Lewis, the freshman, comes in to play the middle guard position now as the football is put back at the 28-yard line of Nebraska. Second down, and they need about 17. It's Andrew Franklin caught behind the line of scrimmage back at the 25 by that freshman from Carroll City, Florida, Johnny Lewis, who's replaced Kinlaw. So time winding down now, and Nebraska is going to be able to turn it around and go with the win. That was the last play of the first quarter. So after 1, Oklahoma leads Nebraska 7-0.
For those parents who
read now to the second quarter of play, you can see how cold it is. The cheerleaders have gone to earmuffs. The ball is at the 25-yard line, third down, And they need 19 for their first down. A holding call may well have stalled this possession, but now Nebraska has the wind at the back, and Sorley will put it up with the wind, and he'll take it deep. He takes it down for Miller, and it is off the hands of Darrell Ray, who had the edge on the ball, and it's going to be a kicking down now for the Nebraska Cornhuskers, and those are the numbers in your first quarter.
Oklahoma with Billy Sims bursting for that big gain and touchdown, but the figures are really meaningless as much as the ball game has been played in Nebraska territory the entire first quarter.
Kick for the formation for Nebraska. Tim Smith is now in to kick for Nebraska. He's a good punter. The heat's on, and he does not get a good kick away. And it rattles around and is put down at the 49-yard line. That was only a 26-yard punt as Oklahoma sent Russell Griffiths in, and Griffiths almost got there along with Greg Sellmeyer. So they put the heat on at the right time.
Heath, we should give credit to the Nebraska defense. They had their backs to the wall three times in that first quarter, and they were able to come out with only one touchdown. Now they have their backs to the wall again at midfield. Oklahoma with good field position.
Oklahoma first down at the 49, leading 7-0. The handoff to Billy Sims.
Ball carries by gets yardage. 20,
Sims. He's grabbed by Rod Horn, number 55, and Bruce Dunning, number 40. Sims now 8 carries and 70 yards and the touchdown.
Nebraska, Keith, is not playing the customary defense against the wishbone. They're playing just what they played all year long.
Overstreet is out. Jimmy Rogers is in now at the right halfback position. Out of the wishbone, the ball is given to Sims again, and Sims moves it from the 46 down to about the 42. He's a yard short of the first down. Bruce Dunning again making the tackle. The attendance, 76,015. That's a sellout. That's 99 consecutive sellouts, which goes back to the second game of 1962 against Iowa State. And they play Missouri here next week, which will give them 100 consecutive home sellouts. Remarkable. Third down and a yard. Sims, and he's got the first down. So Oklahoma getting the football after a 26-yard punt by Tim Smith right their own 49, move for a first down. The ball will be put at the Nebraska 38. Second quarter of play with the Sooners leading by a score of 7-0. Sooners first in the nation, Nebraska fourth in the nation. Lott keeps it, now goes outside with it. The pitch gets away, and it's recovered by Nebraska. It was intended for Jimmy Rogers. The safety man, Hanson, was up there and jumped on the ball. So that's the second time that Hanson has come up with a loose football.
Keith, on the replay, you'll notice the cornerback is going to take Lott after he gets outside the block of the end. Right there is the cornerback, and the safety man is not making the play, and Overstreet made the cardinal error of watching the defensive man instead of the ball.
First down, Nebraska, and the ball is given to I.M. Hip in the lineup at the I-back position or the deep back, and he runs it from the 43 up to about the 47 for four.
And give credit again to the Nebraska defense for stopping that Oklahoma explosive offense again with their backs to the wall.
Well, the pitch that Lott gave to Jimmy Rogers really didn't give Jimmy a whole lot of help and control in getting to it. You have another new man, Tim Wirth, number 25, in there at the up position out of the I formation for Nebraska. Tom Sorley wants to throw it deep. He's going deep. He's got Lockett. It is incomplete, and that was a fine defensive play by Mike Babb. It looked like Lockett had a step on him, but Babb at 6'2", 197, just accelerated and caught him.
Watch the play. It was a beautiful call as he's looking back to the inside while the fake is going on in the backfield. It actually allows the receiver Lockett to get in behind Babb one step, but the ball hung just a little bit too much, and he has to come back, and Babb knocks it down.
And it is third down and 6. Franklin is back in at fullback. Sorley will throw again. He goes to the short man, Miller. Hunt grabs him. Good solid contact by the linebacker, Hunt. but his progress may be just enough. And that's the value of Miller's size right there. He's 6'4", 220 plus.
And a very exceptional athlete. Had basketball scholarships offered to him by Kentucky. But watch him come right across, a little possession pass like a trip shot in basketball, should complete it, and runs for the first down.
The ball is sitting at the Oklahoma 46, and that's the deepest penetration by Nebraska so far in the game. Nebraska offensive line gives the running back time and room, and he hammers in there for about 5 yards. And now, let's spend a moment with Bill Fleming.
Well, Keith, the Orange men of Syracuse have jumped on Navy in the first quarter, 14 to nothing. Maybe taking out a little frustration after losing 18 to 17 last week to Pitt. And Brown ahead of Dartmouth. Okay, Keith.
Yeah, the Orange playing it tough now. Second down, 5. Look at him breaking his iron hip with those powerful legs. Turns his way to the 31-yard line. Isaiah Moses, he has not had the big year this year. He had a year ago, but a lot of reasons for that. One of them is capacity for fumbling.
And the coaches say he's trying to prove he's a tough runner and trying to run over people, Keith, rather than run around them.
It's first down, Nebraska at the Oklahoma 31. Hip. And hip from the 31 down to the 27 for 4. Bruce Tatum makes the tackle. He's a junior out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. Next week, we'll have a double header for you. The lead games to be announced at 12:30 Eastern. At 4 Eastern time, we have USC and UCLA plus other regionals for you. The Trojans playing Washington this week in Los Angeles. It rained hard out there yesterday, so it might be a bit slippery in the Coliseum. Rain, of course, is a commodity the Huskies know well. Second down and 7. A short 7. Sorley wants to put it up, does put it up, and he overthrows Tim Smith going down the sideline. Smith was relatively open, but the ball was overthrown.
Keith, he was pushed out of bounds. Now the new rule this year, he can come back in and catch the ball, and had Sorley waited just a moment longer, I believe he could have found him open for the touchdown because he was open.
Now it is third down and a short 7. With Burns back in the lineup at the I-back position now. Kenny Brown comes to the right side, and Smith goes to the left side. Third and long. And Sorley to throw. Throws it short to Burns. Burns breaks a tackle. Burns gives Nebraska a first down inside the Oklahoma 10-yard line. A gain of 17 yards. Phil Tabor was the fellow who had a hold of Rick Burns, but he breaks that tackle and goes for the big game.
Give Sorley credit. They had the safety blitz on, and the right tackle, Tabor, was trying to contain, but he didn't have the ability to bring Burns down, and Burns is determined to get to that goal line. Great execution.
Just inside the 10-yard line, first and goal to go for Nebraska. Burns in motion. Oklahoma's either offside or there's movement by Nebraska. Darrell Hunt, trying to read the count, I think, was coming too soon and may very well have encroached. It is against Oklahoma. So Nebraska gets a break.
Evidently, Hunt, evidently Sorley changed his snap count to a little longer because Hunt tried to guess and came through and was offsides.
It is now first down and goal to go just inside the 5. The Sooners leading 7-0. Frankly, I thought Nebraska came off about even though they were down by only 7 after one quarter of play. With the wind at their back, they're moving the ball. Burns. course, most everybody figures the team that wins this game will win the conference championship and go on to represent the Big Eight in the Orange Bowl. Actually, what it does right now is slow down the progress of the ball game. Here's Billy Todd now out of Sorley's hole trying for the extra point to tie it. It's all even at 10:06 to go in the first half of play. As Nebraska is very impressive. Those numbers making them the top offensive team in the country, there's a reason for it. And the offensive line, the way it's playing right now, a great part of that story.
Just tuned her up. Figured now was the perfect time. Because Sears has this Craftsman Mechanics tool set on sale. 70 pieces, just $59.99.
So you save over 40%. Whether you get the standard, like my kid sister, or the metric, like me.
I save too, but on Craftsman's big 147-piece set. It's on sale for only $219, and it's just a thing when you're ready for more than...
Rick Burns, the man who said he wants to win this football game and speed through Oklahoma so he can show him his license plate, has just scored the touchdown, and the kick is good, and we're even at 7 with Kelly Phelps and Freddie Nixon, the deep men for Oklahoma, and Todd's kickoff with the win. Go to Phelps. Fumbles it in the end zone. He'll have to cover it. Oh, look at this. Well, now, the young man, under the pressure, tried to break it out of there. He would have been better off to have put it down. He tried to come with it, and he gets to the 6-yard line, and now the Sooners are in trouble.
Keith, it would have been just a touchback, but Phelps is a freshman back there. He lost his poise, thought he had to get the ball back from behind the goal line, and he didn't. The emphasis was put by the kick and not by the Oklahoma team.
So it's Oklahoma at their own 6, and this is where you better be careful. They hand the ball inside, and there just isn't anything there, as Kerry Weinmaster, number 51, the middle guard, met Billy Sims right on the numbers. 9:46 to go. The Nebraska defense has been a swarming red horde so far in this ball game.
Keith, they're getting penetration, something that they did not do last year in the game against Oklahoma.
It's second down. Better part of 11 yards for the Sooners from just outside the 5. They hand it inside to Kenny King. And King is hit by Dunning, linebacker, and Horn, 55, a tackle. As he gets it to the 9. So it is third and long.
And kicking, if they stop them here, they have to kick into the wind. Nebraska would have field position once again with this momentum. You can sense it out on the field. Oklahoma is down.
Freddie Nixon is in at the wide receiver spot now from the 9, third down and 7. And Nebraska holds him. Now they've got to kick it into the wind. They are certain to get good field position as Kerry Weinmaster stuck the Sooner fullback Kenny King.
Weinmaster, Keith, made 2 of the 3 tackles in that series. 2 good plays by the young nose guard.
Only 210.
Yeah, that's right. I was about to say that.
Light for that position. Ray now out of the end zone. Kick is away. Kenny Brown. Retreating some, trying to get some help. He is collared at the Oklahoma 45. And so Nebraska's in business. First down at the Sooner 45-yard line with a score tied at 7. First time in the ball game that Nebraska has taken possession of the ball, first down in Oklahoma territory at the Sooner 45. Sorley gives it to Franklin. Penalty flag down. Franklin goes inside the 40 to the 39, but let's wait for the penalty. You're getting tremendous blocking up front by Kelvin Clark and Barney Cotton. That time, they open the door again, and it's a procedure call against the Cornhuskers. That'll cost them 5. So it'll be back at midfield, first down and 15.
That changes your offensive strategy. You had the momentum. You go right up the middle, a good investment to make those guards and linebackers stay home.
but you get a penalty, and now you have to change your strategy and run some high-risk plays.
Both teams now with a total of 20 yards in penalties on two flags with 8:04 to go in the first half. Rocket wide to the right on first and 15. Hip. I am hip. Gets it to, let's call it the 48. John Goodman, number 72, is down in the bottom of that stack, along with Reggie Mathis, number 58. Mathis out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. Here again, Bill Fleming.
Just a quick note here. Tennessee is out in front of Notre Dame as the Volunteers got down to the one-yard line. Then they had a procedure penalty, and finally Frank Fox ran it in, a 69-yard drive, and the balls are out in front.
Thank you, Bill. Second down and 13 for Nebraska at the Oklahoma 47. Sorry, quick pass. Incomplete. Pass intended for Smith. Played beautifully by Basil Banks, the cornerback. Not fooled a bit.
That was the play, the very daring play. Just a quick look in, and Banks read it quickly and drove right in front of him to break it up and nearly intercept. That was a most unusual play and a reckless play by Banks.
Third down, 13. Charlie, good protection. Now they chase him out of there. Goodman after him. And Tom Sorley runs it inside the 40 to the 39. But that's going to bring up fourth down. Cotton and Lindquist did a great deal there to save their quarterback's life, keeping that big Goodman off his back.
Sorley improvised there. It could have been a big loss. Instead, he picked up 5 or 6 yards.
At the 39, Smith is now the punter. Obviously, he will try, I would think, to knuckleball it down there and let the ball float around. Bounce around deep. No, he nailed it. Got to hit that knuckleball, let it wobble around down there inside that 15-yard line if you can. 60 minutes and 37 seconds as you look at the games that are coming up next here on ABC and the area of the country that will be carrying them. Down east, south, midwest, and the mountain area is going to see a good one, I'll tell you. Stanford, Arizona State might be pretty exciting, too. That Stanford ball club may be the best team I've ever seen to lose four games. They are really exciting. First down from the 20 for Oklahoma. Batted off to the fullback, Kenny King. Out to the 26 he comes. Greg Roberts, the right guard, 260-pound senior out of Nacogdoches, leading the play.
And one of the best offensive players in America. He was a linebacker in high school, moved to offensive guard, and he's been improving every year.
Second down, four Sooners. They're on 26. Kimball wide to the open side of the field. Oklahoma working into the wind. It goes to number 22, Overstreet, the right halfback. He comes across the 30 to the 31, and he's got a first down where Bill Barnett makes the tackle for Nebraska. We're all even at 7 with 6:05 to go in the first half of play.
Give Nebraska defense credit in that they have stopped the speed, the wide plays, so far in this ball game.
Lott. Back to throw. Throws it just about as far as he can for Freddie Nixon, and it bangs off his hands, and it's incomplete. Andy Means was covering on the play. They made contact, however, just as the ball arrived, and Freddie couldn't hang on.
They put Sims at the wide receiver because he's the fastest they have. Look at him run right by the secondary. Excuse me, Nixon. Freddie Nixon, substitute halfback, moved over to flanker for that particular play.
I'll tell you, if the Sooner baseball team's looking for a center fielder or a right fielder, I know a guy that's got a heck of an arm. He threw that thing into the wind 50 yards. Lock. Down he goes. It'll be third down and about 9. Maybe 10. They're going to give him 10. Barnett again right there. He's a junior who's come in and played well along with Derry Nelson. So the ball is just short, they mark it, of the line of scrimmage. So
yep.
It is still third and very long as the Sooners come up now. Victor Hicks is to the tight side of the field. Thomas Lott turns it up, and he is short of the first down. Cooch, number 38, coming across along with Andrews. Here's Bill.
Keith, you'd be happy to know that it's 78 degrees in Jacksonville today. Yeah. Georgia is now leading Florida 7-3 after Berger Premian put the Gators out in front 3-0. Willie McClendon came back with a 3-yard run, climaxing an 88-yard drive, so the Bulldogs are up on top.
They're very much in the hunt for the Southeastern Conference Championship in the fight with Alabama. They do not play, however, this year. Darrell Ray to punt, hits it with his stocking foot, and a fair catch is called by Kenny Brown. Back at the 26-yard line of Nebraska, 35-yard punt into the wind, and time is out with 4.5 minutes to go in the first half. As we have noted, they've sent Richard Turner back into the lineup, taking Jimerson out. That puts the extra lineman in there, what amounts to an 8-man front for the Sooners as Nebraska comes up first down from just outside the 26-yard line, the wind at their back. Ball is given to Rick Burns. Burns just keeps on coming, doesn't he? Boy, what a game he's having. He's out there to right about a first down, close to the 37-yard line.
It's a great second effort on his part, Keith, as you mentioned. He's determined, and he's going in there and going to run over and be his own blocker, as the coaches say. After he runs out of blocking, he becomes his own blocker.
At the 36, they're just a half a yard short of their first down. Let's see if Shirley elects to put it up on second and short. Nope. Burns again. Over the top goes Rick. First down. Huskers at their own 42-yard line. A ball game that is all even at 7-7. And Nebraska, working with the wind at their back, is a very dangerous football team because they are a bunch of freewheelers.
Keith, the Oklahoma defense are double covering their wide receivers and watch for the tight end or the wing back breaking in the middle if they go to the passing game.
From the 42, first down. Burns again. Rick is out close to the 45. George Cumbie, linebacker for Oklahoma, led the tackle. Penn State scoreless in the second quarter against North Carolina State.
North Carolina State played them a great game last year.
Yes, they did. Ted Brown had a Super Bowl game against Penn State last year. Second down, call it 7. From the 45. Breaks it. First down, Nebraska at the Oklahoma 47.
Right behind Clark and Cotton, the two outstanding offensive linemen, opened up a gaping hole, Keith.
71, Steve Glenn is in that offensive front now, 250-pound senior out of Pony City, Nebraska. Ball is near the Oklahoma 47-yard line. First down, Cornhuskers. The one that got away from Bear out of Anniston, Alabama, runs that ball down to the 42. Barney Cotton, the guard, leading the play.
The clock is working now against Nebraska and for Oklahoma.
The ball is on the 42.
2 minutes, 40 seconds to go, first half, 7-7 ball game. Second down, 5. Rick Burns. He actually stumbled over Andrew Franklin's foot as the fullback was making the block. The offensive lineman had given him the door.
Andrew Franklin, Keith, is doing a good job blocking. He's the lead blocker on all of these high formation plays, and he's doing an excellent job on Cumbie and Hunt.
Third down and a yard, a little less than a yard for the first down. Seven-man front. For Oklahoma, the quarterback shoulder sneaks it, and he's got the first down.
Keith, the surprising thing here is that Nebraska's been in their two tight end offense this entire drive, and Oklahoma's been in an 8-man front, and they could not stop them.
That could be a little demoralizing.
Yes, sir.
1:50 to go, first half. Huskers on the march. Franklin and Burns behind Soler. First down, Oklahoma 35-yard line. Ball's down.
Ball carried by Soler.
Quarterback stumbling, coming off the snap, was looking to roll to his left. Lost his footing back to the 40. Jeff Finn was on a fly pattern heading south. But Tom Sorley did not have a chance to get to him. A time is called with 1 minute and 28 seconds to play in the first half by Nebraska. We'll be right back. The football is sitting just outside the Oklahoma 40-yard line. There was a loss of just about 6 yards on that stumble and fall by Sorley as he came off the snap. And so it's second down and 16 as you see what's coming up at halftime. Including the Fireman's Fund flashback, which will be highlights of that great game of the century back in 1971 between these two teams. It figures pass here on second and 16. Lockett got it. He went out of bounds, came back inside, and they wave it off that he was not in bounds when he caught the pass. Darrell Ray was over there, and it was close.
Keith, that was a sensational effort by Lockett. He gets disrupted by his pass pattern by the cornerback, pushed back inside. The ball is right on target, right there. The watch Ray, who is a great football player, searching. Excellent throw right here.
Another angle here and see just how close he was to being inbounds when he caught it. There's one, there's two, and he dropped the ball.
Dropped the ball.
Yep. Okay, third down, and Sorley will put it up. Going deep. No chance on that, and that's thrown in the grandstand.
The pass from Sorley.
With a minute and 16, you would think they would have maybe tried to go short and give Billy Todd a decent crack at it.
That's what penalties. No, they took a loss. No penalty. I'm sorry. First down, a busted play, and Sorley fell is on a busted play for a loss and took them right out of their game plan and the strategy that they had going for them in this drive.
Sitting back out there at the 40, even with the wind, though, that virtual impossibility for Todd, so they send in Smith to punt. Oklahoma doesn't send anybody back with a minute 16 to play. There's the knuckler. Nebraska down to cover it, and they're going to put it away down inside the 10 at about the 7-yard line. Well, in this particular instance, it is the Oklahoma defense getting a little bit of help from the stumble and fall by Sorley, and then two long passes that fail. Score is now becoming obvious out of the eastern part of the country as Clemson has taken a 6-0 lead against North Carolina. That's a big ball game down in the Atlantic Coast Conference. Now let's see if Oklahoma just runs it out. At 1:06 to go in the first half. Of course, I guess you're never running it out when you give it to Billy Sims, are you?
I was going to say the same thing. He's electrified. Every time he gets the ball, you just wonder, is he going to go all the way? He looks like he is. That play was one of those.
Rhodes in at the wide receiver spot now. Kimball comes out, a change for the Sooners. Clock is running at 45. Ball is sitting out at the 14. They keep it on the ground, go to Billy, and Billy dives over the top looking for his first down. And the clock has stopped now as they move the chains as he gets the first down with 35 seconds to go in the first half. A 7-7 ball game. Keep in mind, though, as they come back for the second half and the wind continues to blow and will continue to be a factor, Oklahoma will have it in the third quarter, Nebraska will have it in the fourth quarter. No. The ball is laid on the ground by Overstreet. And Nebraska covers it with 12 seconds to play. Jim Pillen. Now, with the wind, it might be possible for Billy Todd to reach it.
Osmond is mapping his strategy right now to see if he's going to go for one play and then try to call timeout as he has one on the clock, one timeout left. Watch the fumble. It was an inside ride series, second man through, but Overstreet just didn't protect the ball and was stripped out of there by number 81.
Rod Horn, the first man to hit his arm, and then the ball came loose, and Jim Pillen covered it. 12 seconds.
Keith, they're going to. I would think they'll go for a short pass to try to get a little bit closer to the goal post, something over the line of scrimmage, maybe, you know, a delayed pattern, some high percentage pattern, make some run, and then call timeout immediately, and hopefully be close enough to make the field goal and take the lead in this big ball game.
Billy Todd's longest was a 48-yarder, the only score that Nebraska had against Alabama. He's 3 out of 5 between 40 and 49. Sorely looking, and he got Smith out of bounds down at the 4-yard line. 6 seconds to play. He beat Basil Banks. The ball was drilled to Tim Smith, and here comes Billy Todd onto the field.
What a great throw this is, an exceptional catch. That was a fantastic play, and now what do you do? Call timeout and think about it.
Well, he's got Todd on the field. They're not going to think about it. They're going to go for the 3 points and the lead at halftime. Todd from between 20 and 29 yards. He is 4 out of 5 on the season. So let's have another look at it in a different angle and watch the throw here by Sorley.
It's right on the target. One of the toughest passes to throw, right over the linebacker and right on the sideline, but perfect execution by Sorley.
The football is at the 4. Billy Todd is on the field. He will try for the field goal out of the hold of the quarterback Sorley. They've got to go at it from the hash mark, but he's a left-footed kicker. So he's got a little better angle at it, being a left-footer from the right side than he would otherwise. Always a possibility, I suppose, that Sorley will pick it up and throw it. But I suspect Nebraska wants the lead at halftime. A 21-yard field goal attempt right here.
Sorley will hold.
He's 4 out of 5 from this distance. He missed it. He missed it. It hit the right upright and caromed away, and he missed it.
I would have never thought that. Here it is again, the replay of the field goal attempt. He actually hooks it a little bit, it looks like, Keith. It's coming right at the goalpost, right in the middle of your picture. Hits it, ouch, and bounces out.
And 4 ticks remaining on the clock.
Watch his reaction here of the kicker, Todd, number 14. Uh-oh. Disappointment.
That's too bad. Great opportunity for Nebraska, but they don't cash it in. And now Oklahoma snaps the ball to run out the clock, and the first half is over. Tremendous football game between two outstanding football teams. And right now, here is Bill Fleming.
All right, and with me is Tom Osborne. Tom, I'll tell you, this is one great ball game. I know you're disappointed on the field goal, but what a game your defense has played.
Well, they played pretty well. Of course, we had to play well defensively to hold ourselves in the game, and we've been going after it. A lot of hard hitting. It's a great football game, and we just hope we can get things going a little bit better in the second half. But it's going to be a struggle, and I think it may go right down to the wire.
All right, Tom, thanks very much for joining us. Well, we'll be back with more of our halftime activity here in frigid Lincoln right after this word about an upcoming ABC show.
Watch 7, the news people.
Nebraska, 191 to 142 of Oklahoma. It is also significant that Oklahoma has not gotten one single yard via passing. So we'll be back with more of our halftime activities. Right now, this message.
Three, and now he's gone. 44 yards for the touchdown, and Oklahoma was on the board and leading at the end of 1 by a score of 7-0. Nebraska came back to score on a 5-yard run by Rick Burns and had the opportunity to take the lead with 12 seconds to play on this 21-yard field goal attempt. But the ball struck the upright, fell away, and Billy Todd missed and experienced a moment of anguish. And so that's where we are. Instead of Nebraska leading 10-7 at halftime, it's 7-7. Right now, Bill Fleming with Coach Barry Switzer of Oklahoma.
Coach, is this the toughest game you've had so far?
Well, I think so, Bill. I think it's Nebraska's toughest, too. We've made some errors. They've made some. Been a pretty even ball game now. They have assaulted us pretty good, and we've held on the ball. We've assaulted them. I think This half is going to be very interesting for everyone.
You know that fumble that occurred down deep in your own territory, down in their territory, I mean, when you were going in?
Of course, we didn't take advantage of it. Of course, we gave them a great opportunity right before the half. We make a first down and fumble the ball.
Any changes coming up?
No, Bill, we're just going to try to do some. We wanted to take the win in the fourth quarter. We wanted it with Von Schaumann. If it's tight like this in the fourth quarter, Von Schaumann gives us an edge.
Okay, thanks, Barry. All right, Keith, back up to you.
That is a big decision right there, because ordinarily you take the ball to start the second half and try to get some points on the scoreboard. But Barry Switzer elects to take the ball in the fourth quarter, figuring that his defense perhaps can hold on to Nebraska. So the Cornhuskers will have the wind at their back here in the fourth quarter of play. They are the team more given to throw it than is Oklahoma. So let's see whether or not the Sooner defense can hold on to Nebraska's coattail in the third quarter. The Sooners will start out receiving the ball with Thomas Lott, Billy Sims, David Overstreet, and Kenny King in the backfield. Up front, it'll be Hicks, Oubre, Tabor, Farthing, Roberts, Clappin, and Kimball. The deep men for Oklahoma to receive the kickoff from Billy Todd of Nebraska, number 11, Freddie Nixon, and number 7, Kelly Phelps. Phelps is the freshman who fumbled the ball into the end zone, brought it out to the 6. And it was almost expensive for him. All right. Todd to kick it away. Second half underway at a 7-7 ball game. And Phelps at the goal line. He brings it out to the 15 where Tom Vering nails it. And the ball looked like it was squirting around.
It was fumbled, and Barry Joyner recovered it, number 42. Oklahoma has been alert, recovering their own fumbles. They've lost 3, but watch Phelps get hit right there, and the ball comes out, and number 42, Joyner, recovers it.
Look what I found. It was right underneath him. At the 15-yard line for Oklahoma, first down. Ball given to Billy Sims. And Sims gets to the 17, and there he is rolled back. And it is Fisher 16 and Hanson 48. The defensive people for Nebraska, Lawrence Cole in, Rod Horn is the big tackle, Kerry Weinmaster, the middle guard, Dan Pensick, the other tackle, and George Andrews, the defensive end. He's a graduate student using his final year of eligibility. It is second down and 8. King has it, and he is dropped right there. George Andrews really planted him.
Keith, you can see George Andrews, number 96. He has what we call a fullback stunt. You collision him right there, and I don't believe anybody in America can do it any better than Andrews. No gain on the play.
Third and 8 coming up. Freddie Nixon comes into the lineup at a wide receiver spot for Oklahoma, and he's coming down to the bottom of the picture. Third and 8 from the 17. Ball is given to King, the fullback. Andrews is right there again, along with Dan Pensick, number 93. And the Husker defense holds on. Dunning, number 40, is one of the linebackers. And Lee Kuntz, the other, both Coloradans. Tim Fisher at corner. Jim Pillen, the monster man. Andy Means, a cornerback. And Jeff Hansen is the safety. Nebraska will get the ball, good field position, as Darrell Ray kicks off his shoe and prepares to punt into the wind. Not a very good kick, but a rather decent roll as the ball trickles out of bounds at the Nebraska 48-yard line. It was a 34-yard punt, but the roll was what made it work. And so here's Nebraska now, right in the middle of the football field for their first offensive possession behind Tom Sawyer. You'll find Rick Burns, Andrew Franklin, and Kenny Brown. The offensive front that's been so impressive, Miller, Clark, Cotton, Saulfield, Lindquist, Orton, Smith. Inside the Oklahoma 48, Darrell Hunt, number 85, along with John Goodman.
Here's a first quarter score of
on the replay, Darrell Hunt, All-American last year, 120 tackles, does exactly what a linebacker is supposed to do, plug the hole once he sees the path of the ball carrier. He is a good one.
Gain four, second down six at the Sooner 48. Burns on a sweep. Sooner stringing out very well, stopping at the 46-yard line. Again, Darrell Hunt right there.
That's the speed of your defensive line at Oklahoma.
Reggie Mathis, defensive end. John Goodman, defensive tackle. Reggie Kinlaw is the nose guard. Bill Tabor, a tackle. And the other defensive end is Bruce Tatum. They got that big tackle Turner back in there replacing Jemerson. And they've got what amounts to an eight-man front up there now facing Nebraska on third down and four. And it's Rick Burns. He ran through one tackle. He is close to his first down, but I don't think he has it. Darrell Hunt and John Goodman were the two people, again, that stopped him. George Cumbie arrived just a fraction late.
They're going for it, Keith.
Linebackers are George Cumbie and Darrell Hunt for Oklahoma. There they are. And the defensive secondary men, Basil Banks, young sophomore, Jay Jimerson, another sophomore, Mike Babb, a senior, and Darrell Ray, a junior, on fourth and a half yard. Nebraska gambling. Burns. He did not make it. Number 74, Bill Tabor, made the biggest defensive play of the ball game.
The after effects of running on fourth down and not making it changes the momentum more drastically, Keith, I think, than any other way in football. Let's see what happens.
Tabor just looped outside and came right in, and he locked Rick Burns before he could get to the top of the stack. And now, here are the Sooners. First down out at their 43-yard line. Third quarter of play, and the score tied at 7-7. Out of the wishbone. Billy Sims. And Sims is to the 49 for 6 yards, where Lee Kuntz makes the tackle. Sims now with 91 yards of the ball game on 14 carries.
That's the first good first down game that they've had in a long time. The lack of success on first down has hurt Oklahoma's wishbone.
They've only averaged 2.5 through the first half. Second man gets it. Ball is loose. Nebraska dives. The Huskers have it. Overstreet hit hard and coughed it up. Barry Nelson covered it. That's the fourth turnover by the Sooners. Dan Pensick, number 93, made it happen.
What a tackle Pensick made. He's the right defensive tackle. Overstreet, number 22, lowers his hip, and Pensick just knocks the ball loose with his helmet. Big play for Nebraska.
At midfield, first down for the Huskers. Tom Sorley batted away. Bill Tabor one more time. So that big 6'4", 244-pound senior out of Houston is almost single-handedly holding the Huskers here in this third quarter.
He's an outstanding athlete. Started for them for 3 years. His brother's a starter on the offensive team. They're twins, obviously.
If he hadn't cut his hand, though, he'd have been playing center probably. Second down and 10. High and hip. Right at the 50. John Goodman, the other tackle, made that stop. There's Nelson, who recovered the fumble for the Huskers.
Keith, this is a good example of why first down is so important. Incomplete on first down forces them into a wide game, a risk offense, and now third and 10.
Sorley looking, goes for Miller, he's got it! Dick Jr. Miller, 6'4" tight end, downfield, makes the catch. First down Nebraska, Oklahoma 17. The ball lofted over Reggie Mathis, the defensive end who had gone back to cover.
Watch this coverage, the defensive end, Mathis has Miller.
man for man, but Miller outruns him, obviously, and gets the pass before the safety can react up.
Nebraska at the Oklahoma 17, first down. Shorley option down the line to Ian Hip. And he's rolled out of bounds. At the 12, he gained 5. Mike Babb rolled him out.
Keith, they have got to get some points on the scoreboard while they've got the win, because the fourth quarter, as Barry Switzer said, they'll have that momentum, and the ball game has been played on the side of the field with the team going into the win so far.
At the 11, second down and 4. And lunges for another yard. He was looking for the stack, trying to go over it, and the stack collapsed under him, and all of a sudden he found a foot on the ground and he got an extra yard.
That lunge, that twist, that determined effort on the goal line is all the difference to whether you have third and 5 and have to pass, or third and 1 to make it first down in 2 tries.
In the acquisition of real estate, it is the small factors that make the total difference. Here's 1 yard right here that is very important on third down. Hip. He's got it. He's got a touchdown. Todd is on the field at 9:25 to go in the third quarter to try for the extra point. Extra point, very important. Remember Missouri, Colorado? Gotta be good the way the crowd reacted, and it is. And so the Nebraska Cornhuskers recovering the fourth Oklahoma fumble. Take it in from 50 yards to lead it 14-7.
This is it!
America, if you want a good-looking, full-size wagon with a handy...
The first time in the 1978 football season, the Oklahoma Sooners are behind. 14-7. Reason? Nebraska's run off 55 plays. Oklahoma has run off 35 plays. Todd's kickoff. Short, felt, 10. Look out. He got outside to the 26 before the Cornhuskers close on him, and let's go back to the touchdown.
It's the sweep on third down and a foot to goal. What a daring call, but look at the blocking by the right side of the offensive line. They open up a gaping hole. Watch Franklin's block, number 39. His assignment is to cut off the linebacker. Right there, he chops him down and opens up this gaping hole. I say again, Tom Osman deserves the credit.
Oklahoma to the attack from the 27-yard line now, and Billy Sims carries for the Sooners.
That play's worth looking again, because they had gotten stopped on fourth down and a foot by running in the middle, so he chose to gamble and go outside, and he fooled the entire Oklahoma defense.
Sims goes from the 27 out to the 31 for 4 yards. He now has 96 in the ball game, according to our statistician, Mr. Mike Swanson. And time is called now by Oklahoma. The Sooners take timeout. They have 2 left, 8:47 to go in the third quarter, and the Huskers lead them 14-7.
We play to win for our policy owners. Today we've got another opportunity. George here's got a wife, 2 kids, and a mother. He needs life insurance protection badly, and we've got to get it for him. We're going to block out money problems, protect him against financial disaster. Okay, let's go! Take the worry off his shoulders! Protect his family! You've made it, George! Financial security!
Where the name of the game is life, there's New York Life.
The nation's only 2 undefeated, untied major teams are in jeopardy today. In this game, Oklahoma is trailing, of course, Nebraska, and Penn State is trailing North Carolina State, a team that was an underdog by 3 touchdowns, Keith.
Surprise, Bill, from the 31. Oklahoma, give it to the fullback, Kenny King. King trying to slant up the middle, runs into Pinzik, that big junior tackle from Columbus, Nebraska, and he goes down. North Carolina State people so excited over there, and he is a truly great running back, Ted Brown, and the Heisman vote. I've been subjected to a letter writing campaign from the folks out of Raleigh, but I must tell all of you who have been spending your postage money, I don't have a vote. Third down and 3. Thomas Locke gets his first down and then some. Finally out of bounds. He is near and at the Nebraska 45-yard line. David Overstreet threw one good block to turn him upfield, and so Thomas Watt keeps the ball and goes big with it.
Keith, this is the first time they've run the reverse option, faking the fullback to the left and coming back and pulling the off guard, and they have a gaping hole as Nebraska was fooled by that particular fake.
Watt gained 22. They mark him at the Nebraska 44. Huskers lead 14-7. The ball given to Overstreet. And he's down to the 40 for 4 yards. Dunning and Pillen, the tackle for the Huskers. And we go inside 8 minutes to play in quarter number 3.
Neither of those plays are basic wishbone plays. One was a trap option, and that was a base isolation play with a fullback and other off halfback leading.
Just inside the 40, second down 6. Second man is Sims. And he's to about the 35. They'll be looking at a little bit more than a yard on their third down play. Sims has now gone over 100 yards, 16 carries for 101. Nixon is in at the wide spot, and Rhodes comes out. Third and 1. Sims dives for it. It just depends on how much advance they get it. If they give him the full yard, he'll have it. How far did the body fall forward? It's close enough for the chain. Andrews, Kuntz, and Fisher on that defensive play, and little Fisher came up to meet him at the top of the stack.
And turned him back. That's one of the few times, Keith, I was going to say, that Sims doesn't twist and fall forward on that particular play, knowing it's short yardage and not running for a touchdown.
Just that much.
Two tight ends into the ball game, Keith, so that they can run either side equal as well.
For the first down on fourth down. Lott keeps it, tries to wriggle for it, and a penalty flag goes down.
He fumbled the ball, Keith.
And Nebraska has it. The Huskers come out with it. Pillen, number 29, comes out with the ball. But just hold everything, because I think the whistle had sounded. Offside against Nebraska. That's clearly the call by Earl Shostrom, the referee. Offside against Nebraska. And Oklahoma will get its first down.
Oklahoma trailing, Keith, but they've had some unusual breaks happen for them. Otherwise, Nebraska could be a couple of 3 touchdowns ahead of them, such as that particular play.
And the ball has bounced when they've laid it down. On most instances, it's bounced back to them. But they have still turned it over 4 times. Now the football is just inside the 30. First down for the Sooners. Thomas Lott gives it to Billy Sims. He breaks it up the middle, and he is gone. Touchdown. His second of the day. Electrifying Billy Sims bolting in for the touchdown. And an Oklahoma man is down on the field. I've not been able to see his number. Uwe von Schumann coming in for the extra point try. If he makes it, it'll be 117 in a row.
Keith, the touchdown run was the identical play that he scored earlier. The Nebraska safety man had moved over to the right. Here's the replay. Two leading backs, number 30 and number 22, King and Overstreet, open up the hole, and the safety man is not there. He won't come in the picture till Sims has run deep into the secondary. You'll see Hanson, 48, finally come in the picture. Too late.
Now here's the try to tie. It is good. With 6 minutes and 47 seconds to play in the third quarter, the Sooners come storming back and tie the game at 14. An offside penalty call against Nebraska, a very big call in that possession for Oklahoma.
Surprisingly that Oklahoma was that lucky on that play, but on a short yardage, Keith, sometimes you get over-anxious and you line up offside. I didn't see anybody jump offside.
And a marvelously gifted athlete carrying the ball.
What an athlete he is. Let's look at the touchdown again. The block of Greg Roberts, he double-teams Widemaster on the nose. The two backs lead through. The safety man had moved over the double-team to the wide side of the field, and therefore he's not in a position to support the run, and he is too late getting there. Sims cuts away from him and pulls up those legs. That's a little running drill that Oklahoma uses. I've seen that in practice.
Well, they're doing something right down there, I'll tell you that.
It's some ball game, though. It's outstanding plays. They've got Vincent. Fierce collisions.
Looking for the coach.
That's him.
That's him right there.
All right. The kickoff now. Kenny Brown and Frank Lockett are deep for Nebraska. Von Schumann's kick will go into the wind. With his leg, he should carry it pretty deep. Well, he doesn't. He sort of hooks it over to the sidelines, and it's picked up at the 12-yard line by Kenny Brown, and he runs into nothing but white shirts. He was going to the open side of the field looking for the wall, and he just simply wasn't there. Basil Banks, the first one to get to him. And these are the games that are following this one in the areas of the country where you will see it. So stay with us. We've got all kinds of fun for you before the day is done.
LSU's got some momentum going with Charles Alexander. They've got a chance against Alabama in Birmingham.
Nebraska now. First down at the 17. 14-14 ball game. Nebraska with the wind in the third quarter. The Sooners will have it in the fourth. Swing it out. And it is high in hip. Trying to get upfield with it, but coming across is Basil Banks, number 17, to take him down. The story of the Sooner drive as hip's movement of the ball is to the 19. Or about 2, 2nd and 8 coming here.
Only 2 minutes and 38 seconds to go 73 yards, which shows the explosiveness of this Oklahoma offensive team.
Breaks it over the left side and breaks it out close to a first down, running behind Barney Cotton one more time. Their scores now out of the Big Ten, Michigan beating Northwestern. The Wolverines face Purdue next week in a big, big ball game in the Big Ten. Georgia now pulling away from Florida at halftime. Georgia and Alabama do not play. If they both finish undefeated in conference play, it'll be Georgia going to the Sugar Bowl because Alabama was there the last time. Look at that one, 14-3 Syracuse over Navy at halftime. Here's the first down for the Huskers and on the sweep, Rick Mann. Runs bang into Bruce Payton, the defensive end, but he still gets a rather decent gain out of it. Burns now has carried 20 times for Nebraska for 81 yards.
And each time he carries the ball, Franklin is taking on either an end, a linebacker, or a tackle. He's going to have a headache when the game is over.
He's a pretty good-sized horse himself, though, at 195, 197 pounds. Second down and 7 from the 30. Ball is loose. Oklahoma. Now to change your mind. Craig Johnson, number 30, who had come in there at the I-back position. And let's have a look at it. It's close, the call.
The ball bounced up to Johnson, and then as he goes down, the ball comes wiggling out.
But he reaches back and grabs it, I guess, Keith. No, he doesn't either.
Well, whatever. Wow. It is still Nebraska's ball. Third down at the 30. That could have gone either way. They went for Nebraska. Burns is back in at the I back now. Soreless pass. He is off the hand of Miller, the tight end. Big Junior Miller could not hold on to it. But don't despair. Remember, it was Junior who made the catch that set up the big move by the Nebraska Cornhuskers in the second quarter.
Defensively, Oklahoma is double covering the receivers, which means they must go to the tight end or the halfbacks.
Punting time program, a special exclusive of ABC Sports. Let's pause 5 seconds to allow our local stations to identify themselves.
KETV Channel 7, Omaha.
Tim Smith to punt. We've got a new punter. It's Billy Todd in to hit it, and he hits a beauty. Back to Nixon. Way back. Then they bury him. Billy Todd, the place kicker, did the punting. And he hit a beauty. And Oklahoma gets the ball first down at their own 23-yard line. Football tomorrow night, the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Los Angeles Rams. Not much really necessary to say about that. They're two big boys. Sims is caught behind the line of scrimmage by George Andrews. Dropped inside the 20-yard line. So the great defensive end of the Cornhuskers read that play just right.
Let's isolate on George Andrews, the left defensive end. It's a reverse play. The guard's supposed to pull out and trap him out, number 73, but he couldn't get there to him because of the quickness of Mr. Andrews. Sensational play on first down.
He used all of the appendages, too, didn't he? Ball is back at the 19. It is second down and 14 for the Sooners. And it's the up man out of the wishbone, Kenny King. And he gets it back out to the 20 or so. Lee Koontz and Jim Pillen gang up to make the tackle. There's Tom Osborne pacing the sidelines. Quiet man. I think a heck of a coach.
An excellent coach, a good tactician right there. Now Oklahoma has third down, Keith. They've got to try something high risk to make the first down. Otherwise, Nebraska will have field position.
Barry Switzer has made up his mind. The play's in. It's third and 11, and Thomas Lott down the line with it and cannot get around the corner. Derry Nelson, the other defensive end for Nebraska, made that play, and it brings up a fourth down. So the Huskers should get the ball in good field position, but there's only 2 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in the third quarter, and then Oklahoma will have the win. Well, the Dukers are on top of Wake Forest Demon Deacons by a field goal. Fourth down, and the punt by Darrell Ray. Spins it into the wind. Kenny Brown fair catches it for Nebraska. First down up at the 43. That was a 35-yard punt. I keep talking about the win because I keep remembering what Barry Switzer said. We want the win in the fourth quarter. And we want Uwe von Schaumann, if necessary, to have the advantage.
Tough decision for him to make because he would prefer having to win the third quarter and trying to get ahead.
The Huskers with the ball at the 43, a 14-14 ball game. The right side of the Nebraska line moved a little bit quick. I think Steve Lindquist beat the count by a fraction. That'll cost him five. I was about to say that Oklahoma got a touchdown anyway against the wind in the third quarter. That may be a very big thing. Now here's Bill.
All right, Keith, with 10 minutes to go in the third quarter, Matt Barr has kicked his 19th field goal of the season, and the Nittany Lions are now trailing North Carolina State by 1 point. Barr, incidentally, had one earlier in the first quarter to get Penn State out and running. Okay, Keith.
Thank you. Back the ball goes to the 38-yard line. Nebraska now 30 yards on four penalties. First and 15. Shirley rolls it back to throw. He goes deep for Lockett. Tried to pull it down one-handed, but by that time he was out of bounds. Ball hung up in the wind.
He was behind Banks, Keith.
Started floating on him a little bit, though.
Here it is. It's a fake play-action pass to put 1-on-1 coverage, and Lockett runs right by Banks, and the ball's thrown just a little bit outside off the field, and yet Lockett tries to make a sensational catch. Just couldn't quite hold it.
Sorley now 6 out of 17 for 93 yards. Lots 0 for 2. Weather conditions having a lot to do with it. Minute 59 to go in the third quarter. Second down, 15. I am hip with the ball. And he moves it from the 38 back up to around the 43. So that'll bring up a third and 10. Kinlaw made the stop.
The last time they were in this position, they went right down the middle to Junior Miller for a big play.
Wind has this kind of velocity, you really can't get that ball up. Can't put it up. You have to have a relatively flat trajectory. Sorley goes for Lockett and gets him at the Oklahoma 36-yard line. Boy, he drilled that one.
It was a rifle shot. Watch the replay. Lockett is going to turn inside. There are three Oklahoma defenders around him, but Sorley throws the ball right on the numbers where it has to be caught.
Jemison, Ray, and Tatum all back there.
Low play action pass, but long yardage. The defense had dropped off the double cover, and they completed against the double coverage.
And it's first down at the Sooner 36-yard line. As hip.
Ball
and skips for about three as he gets to the 33. If he had not really committed himself so much inside, if he just skipped to the outside.
He had some running room, but George Cumby, collision, the fullback Franklin back in the Nebraska backfield, and there was really no place to run.
40 seconds now to play in the third period. Second down and 7. Sorley's pass, Lockett. Lockett is caught by Basil Banks, number 17, who came up from his cornerback position and made a heck of a play.
You stop a screen, Keith, by tackling him before he gets started, before the blockers can get there, and Banks recognized it and made the play.
And time is called by Nebraska now. Each team with 2 remaining, 14 seconds to play in the third period. The score is tied 14-14. The Huskers trying to use the win here in the third quarter to get ahead again.
7 to 10% annually in recent years.
Third and 10.
Next week, our NCAA doubleheader. The lead games will be announced later in the week. Check your local listings for those games. But at 4 Eastern time, we will bring you as the feature attraction the UCLA Bruins and the Southern California Trojans in a ball game that could be, and I qualify saying could be, the big game in the Pac-10. And I say could be because the Trojans are in against the Washington Huskies in Los Angeles today.
Washington has an outstanding defensive football team.
Yes,
they come to play, is the old saying.
College football tomorrow with Bill Fleming offers highlights of those contests that are being played. You see there are a lot of good ones to be seen. All right, it's third down and 10 for Nebraska. They throw it to Franklin, the fullback, and he's got the first down. Daring call again.
What a sensational call. Oklahoma were rushing as fast as they could. Set up the draw play. Look at the play. Watch the Oklahoma defense take off and rush. Franklin is hidden in behind the offensive center and watch him make the extra yardage. Right there, they gave him a first down.
At the Oklahoma 24-yard line, Barry Switzer on the sidelines on a cold day. And time has run out in the third quarter. And after 3, we're all even at 14.
To every secretary who ever asked why centering a line can't be automatic, and why setting up columns and indenting and underlining and erasing too can't be automatic, to all those secretaries, IBM says, wait till you get your hands on this. The new IBM electronic typewriter. So automatic that while you fold the letter, it types the envelope. Now that's automatic.
lot of motor oils offer you protection. Some offer you gasoline mileage, too. Avalon Super Premium has been tested for both. Tests in state trooper cars for over 4 million miles proved Havoline really protects. And in a test against the leading 10W-40 oil advertising extra gasoline mileage, Havoline couldn't be beat. So get an oil that's been trooper tested and mileage tested. Get Havoline Super Premium from Texaco.
Sunday, Bob Hope visits Pat Boone, daughter Debbie, and the whole family for Thanksgiving special.
Cut yourself in on the convenience. Open a new Money Service daily account for $100 or more at First Federal Lincoln now and get a handy utility knife free. Then add bill paying to your account and get this 17-piece knife set as a bonus gift. Money Service daily is convenient any way you slice it. Money Service saves, earns, pays your bills. Stop in any First Federal Lincoln office and open your account now.
First Federal Lincoln wants to help your dreams come true. First Federal.
Like a mountain morning sunrise coming slowly through the trees. Like an eagle when it spreads its wings.
We received word that Tim Smith, the Nebraska punter, is out with a Charlie horse. That's why we stopped doing the punting. Go to the fourth quarter. First down, Nebraska at the 24-yard line. Red, it's Franklin, the fullback, all the way down close to the 15-yard line. Third quarter numbers at Oklahoma yet to gain a yard through the air.
Look at the stats. Nebraska has a big advantage in first downs. Total yardage, and the score is still tied. And look at the turnovers. Four for Oklahoma and only two for Nebraska.
67 offensive plays for Nebraska, 45 for Oklahoma. Second down, yard and a half. High end hip, cut down at the line of scrimmage by George Cumbie, number 28. Oklahoma and Nebraska. Remember the thing we point we made very early, that Nebraska has not scored on Oklahoma in the fourth quarter since 1971. It's third down. They still need that yard and a half. Shortly the quarterback. Right in behind Cotton, Lindquist, and Saulfeld, the center. Looks like he's got his first down. He does.
Keith, when Nebraska go to two tight ends, Oklahoma put their extra lineman in, and the weakness is right over the middle. They have the guards covered, no one over the center. The sneak is the best and most consistent play in that situation.
Somebody trying to tie a shoe down there, and they may have to call a timeout. But they'll go to the snap of the ball and take the play. Now the Barney Cotton gets back to his position. They send hip in motion, and that gets a penalty flag. That, a little bit of indecision. They didn't want to spend the time out there. He had shoe untied, and because of the lack of indecision there, that's going to cost him 5 yards for illegal procedure.
You can see Cotton, who had been tying his shoe, he didn't get in the huddle. He didn't know the snap count. And he dropped back too quickly, and it's a 5-yard penalty.
It was going to be a fast play. You can tell from that, the way Barney came back.
Now, one of the reasons he didn't have to go to the huddle, in Nebraska calls, in that situation, check with me at the line, and they go up and call the play after they get the line of scrimmage.
First down and 15 as the ball is put back at the 18-yard line, and they give it to Andrew Franklin, the fullback, and he gets back to the 14. So he got 4 of the 5 yards back.
You put the man in motion in that particular situation, Keith, so the tailback can kind of distract the guards, and hopefully they'll think outside or pass and run the trap right up the middle, but it didn't surprise Oklahoma's Kinlaw.
The two speedsters are back in now, Brown and Lockett, and they go into the wide receiver position. With hip, the deep man. From the 14, second down. And 11. Go to hip. He tries to break out of there. He just could not get away from the grasp of Reggie Kinlaw, the middle guard, who got him by a leg and held on.
If he hadn't, he'd have walked into the end zone, because Oklahoma had moved all of their defensive men to the wide side of the field, and the secondary could not have gotten back to make the play.
Now it is third down and 9 from the 12. Nebraska calls timeout. They want to get their act together with 12:29 to play in the game.
Get ready to deal. Get ready to drive. Now, during Chevy truck tryout time at your local participating Chevy dealers. Get behind the wheel of those great new Chevy trucks. Try them out for available features. Try them out for comfort. Try them out for ride. Don't miss a deal now during your Chevy dealer's big Chevy truck tryout time.
Am I too late?
Third down coming up for the Cornhuskers now as the quarterback Shirley called the time. And I don't particularly admire the timing of the timeout because they gave up 5 yards on Barney Cotton having to put his shoe back on because of procedure. Now here they are. Big play time from the 12. Shirley gives it on the draw to Andrew Franklin, who breaks out of there. And he gets the ball down to about the 8-yard line. Jimerson finally was successful in putting the big guy down, but he is a tough runner. Now it is fourth down. Billy Todd is in the game for the field goal try. He missed one in the closing seconds of the first half. Shirley will hold on a 24-yard pass attempt. He's got it up. He's got it in the middle of the upright. And with 11 minutes and 51 seconds to play, Nebraska takes the lead 17-14, and they have broken a drought. They've scored for the first time in the fourth quarter against Oklahoma since 1971.
That is phenomenal. It just couldn't happen with as fine an offensive football team as Nebraska's had.
Now let's check some other key scores around the country with Bill.
Oh, and a big one in the Big Ten. Wisconsin is leading Purdue at halftime, 6-3 on a 38-yard touchdown pass from Mike Kalispicki to Ron Sidner. And Penn State now on the third field goal of the game by Matt Barr and is leading North Carolina State. Notre Dame on a block punt by John Krim, and then Kent Buchanan took it in to score. So with 11:44 left to go in the third quarter in that one, the Irish are up on top. All right, Keith.
Thank you, sir. Todd will kick off now into the wind. They have Phelps and Nixon deep. Oklahoma with the wind at their back. Nebraska leading 17-14. 2 years ago when we all almost froze to death here later in the year. Bitter cold day. There was a young man named Woody Shepherd who threw a halfback option pass that set up Oklahoma's 21-17 victory 2 years ago here.
And the flea flicker was a difference.
Yes, he was very much in evidence too, wasn't he? Here's the kick. It's Phelps. Oh, he almost stepped out. I think they're going to call it dead. They're going to call him down at the 18-yard line. The linesman has not moved. He marked it right at the 18 as John Rood was downfield, just leveled him. That's another quick whistle. I do not believe that he was down.
Keith, I have not seen that violent a collision in a long time. And of course, watch it right here, 46, John Rudd, I guess it was, wasn't it, Keith? Right there, and the ball is coming out. That.
Well, and I think if you take it back, you'll see the ball is still in the crook of his arm when his knee goes down. Go back and let's see if we can pick it up.
Officials have a way of going, taking it the easy way on that style, type of play, but that is clearly a fumble.
Yes, it's a fumble. No question about it. Yep. It is loose. Tom Osborne was on the field to protest it, but there's not much you can do about it. And they call the ball, call the ball carrier.
What he's doing right here, what Tom Osborne is asking is the other official to overrule. If one official didn't see it, Keith, you can't have another official overrule, and that's what they're screaming about.
Phelps is still down on the field. Osborne has argued his case as much as he can under the circumstances. But that is I've got to say it's a bad call because the ball is loose, obviously, right there.
That's about the baddest call as you'll ever see.
Yep.
In a critical game like this, in a critical area,
Nebraska would have had the football down inside the 15-yard line. No, not the case. It's given to Oklahoma, and I mean that literally, given to Oklahoma at the 19. Offensive right side of the line of the Sooners jumped too quick, gets a penalty flag. Greg Roberts, I think, moved a little quick on it. Not much gain on the play. It's a procedure call against the Sooners.
And that takes them out of their wishbone offense. Normally, when it's first and 15, they will go to a different style of play other than the wishbone, either the I formation or deep handoff or pitches to Billy Sims.
Ball is back now at the 14-yard line. It's first down and 15 for Oklahoma. Billy Sims. You don't think his name isn't on everybody's mind right now? Lock. Hit behind the line of scrimmage and down back at the 2-yard line. Andrews hit him first and then Derry Nelson put him away.
George Andrews, number 96. One of the great defensive ends. Watch him crash in and just lasso Lott right there. Lott breaks away, but by then, his teammates come and make the play.
Loss of 12 back to the 2-yard line. Sooners got a big, big break on that quick call on the kickoff return. But they make a mistake, cost them 5, and now the quarterback is nailed behind the line of scrimmage all the way back to the 2. And that's going to be too much time, I think, against the Sooners. Back judge calls it. That's right. That'll cost them another yard. They've got to go to the 29-yard line for the first down. So it is going to be second down and 28 from their 1-yard line.
Keith, Oklahoma against Nebraska against Missouri a few years ago was in the same situation, and little Washington went the distance.
I tell you that Kelly Phelps, who absorbed that whack from Rude on that controversial play, has a shoulder injury. Kelly really took a whack. Just two strong young men going full speed. Out of the end zone, they give it to King, and Kenny breaks it. He may run for a week. What a big play. Kenny King with a great block from Rhodes turned it upfield, and the Sooners are out of the hole.
Watch it again. Double team linebacker, and King cuts back out the back door, as we say. Picks up his wide receiver, knows that he's going to get a block from Rhodes, and he does, and there's the 9-6 speed, and he came close to going all the way.
47 yards. First down, Oklahoma at the 48. Billy Sims punches to the Nebraska 49. That's the explosive nature of this Oklahoma offense.
I hope I didn't jinx Nebraska by saying what happened a few years ago in a very similar situation.
Second down. And 7. And it's Billy Sims. He gets to the 46 before Bruce Dunning spins him back. Big, big, big play by Kenny King.
Woo. He was picking them up and putting them down. Woo!
9:50 to play in the ball game. 17-14 Nebraska. Third down and 5. Luck. Outside it goes, and Overstreet is flanked out of bounds by Tim Fisher. But they've got the first down.
Came back with misdirection option. The fake of the fullback, opposite away, they're going to run the option. Held the linebackers and sealed them off and got a big gain.
But what a big call that was on that kickoff fumble. Wow. First down Sooners at the 36. Thomas Lott dives inside. He gets a couple of yards, and again it's Dunning on the tackle.
Keith, for the first time, Nebraska are gambling with their defense. They had been playing their basic five-man front all the ball game. Now they're using some safety blitzes and trying to give Oklahoma a bad play.
Second down, eight coming up. 34-yard line of Nebraska. Thomas Lott drops the ball and covers it at the 35.
Keith, he was just holding the ball in one hand, as we saw earlier. It appeared to me that he just kicked it out with his knee, because he's holding the ball in one hand where he can make the cut more easily than tucking it away.
It is third down and nine now for Oklahoma at the Nebraska 35. That's what he did. He just flipped right out of his hands. Old Cole football. Bobby Kimball, wide open side. Steve Rhodes. It's Rhodes over there. It is Lott keeping, and Thomas Lott breaks it, and Lott goes for the first down at the Nebraska 22-yard line.
Once again, the trap reverse option, pulling the off guard, Tabor leading the play. We've seen that so much this year.
Kenny King makes the big play to get Oklahoma some operating room, and now it's Thomas Lott coming up with a big play. First down at the 22 of Nebraska. Billy Sims cuts it in the middle. Fumble. Ball loose. Nebraska gets it. Pinsick has the ball.
Holy cow.
Well, I guess everything evens out. At least I'm sure this officiating team, that linesman in particular, hopes it does. The story on the Sooners and their ball handling, they fumbled nine times in the game today. They have lost it five times. First down, Huskers at their own 20, going into the wind. It'll be difficult to throw the ball. Give it to Rick Burns, and Burns, slashing over the right side, gets to the 23, where George Cumbie makes the tackle. About as tough a football game as you're ever going to want to see, isn't it?
Good athletes. Well-coached football team, both coaching staffs prepared their team beautifully for this game.
Second down and seven for Nebraska. Huskers lead 17 to 14. Here's the reverse. George Cumbie knocks him down back at the 15-yard line. Loss of eight on the play. They've been saving it. You know they've been saving it. They had to use it sooner or later, and it backfired.
Keith, on the reverse, actually, Oklahoma was not fooled. The defensive end had dropped off the double cover, and they ran right back into where he had dropped off the double coverage.
Now it's third down and 15 for Nebraska from their own 15. Sorley wants to throw. He has a lot of time, but he has no target. And he has to pull it down. He gets out to the 21, where Basil Banks brings him down, and it's fourth down. And Oklahoma is sure to get good field position. Here's Bill.
I'll say this, Keith. Penn State's in quite a battle right now. Matt Barr kicked his fourth field goal of the day to make it 12-7. And then Mason Ritter came back with a 42-yarder for North Carolina State. And Notre Dame now has edged ahead of Tennessee on a 36-yard field goal by Chuck Mayo. Okay.
And Billy Todd is in to punt. Into the wind. Sooners bound to get that ball up around midfield unless they mishandle it. There's the fair catch by Darrell Ray, and Oklahoma has the ball. First down, just short of the Nebraska 47-yard line. 27-yard punt.
Superstop.
Those are the other games that you'll be seeing following this one. Stanford, Arizona State in the West, Tulsa, Wichita State, William & Mary, East Carolina, Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo, and UC Davis. It's first down for Oklahoma, just short of the Nebraska 47-yard line, and Billy Sims hammers it down to about the 46. Let's give him 2 yards on it, close to the 45. Make it second down and eight. You see Oklahoma with two timeouts remaining, and Nebraska has one. Nebraska's now run 72 plays, and that was the 55th for Oklahoma. Second down and eight. Thomas Lott. And he's at the 41 before he is scythed down by Jim Pillen.
Keith, that was the reverse option to the open side of the field, which they haven't used so far. And it looked like there was a hole, but the speed of Nebraska recovered.
It's third down and four. Same play. Looked to me like that ball almost came loose again, but they blow it dead there as Thomas had it out in that one end at the 39-yard line. Pillen again defensively for Nebraska.
Pillen has made some fantastic plays. As we said earlier, against the wishbone, your secondary are no more than linebackers. And how can you not give so much credit to the Nebraska defense for the way they have had their backs to the wall against the number one offensive football, running offensive football team in America, and yet they've held them to 14 points.
Timeout call by Oklahoma. Both teams now with one timeout remaining, the Huskers leading 17-14.
These fully race-prepped Chevy Camaros will be driven by 12 of the best drivers in the world in the International Race of Champions. Introducing the 1979 version of the Ultimate Camaro. The Camaro Z28. From people who know what performance is all about. Chevrolet.
4:49 to play in the ball game. Fourth down, 2 yards to go. Oklahoma. Nebraska goes to a goal line defense, putting the big linemen in, and they stack them up front. They've got a seven-man front. They pitch it outside to Overstreet, and he's home free. First down and then some. As they gambled, they went wide with it. They had Nebraska committed to the goal line front, and it's a gain of 13 yards, and the Sooners have a first down at the Nebraska 24-yard line.
The key block was made by the tight end, Valerie, on their safety man, who was supposed to support outside of the cornerback, but the fake of the fullback, he froze momentarily, and the block took place.
Oklahoma now 310 yards on the ground, nothing in the air. 17-14, Nebraska first down Sooners. They're moving. Lott pitches it outside. And good defensive flow by the Huskers. Gary Nelson brings Sims down. He gained a, maybe not, not going to give him a thing. The ball is put down right at the 24. The clock is running at 4:25 to play in the game.
Good pursuit by the Nebraska defense. The pitch was out, and the inside pursuit got there in time to stop Sims.
Osborne has never beaten Oklahoma. Switzer has never lost to Nebraska. Second down and 10. Kenny King, the fullback, and he's to the 20. That's 4 yards. 4 yards for Kenny King, who broke the big, big play a little while ago to get the Oklahoma Sooners off the hook when they were back at their one-yard line. Uwe Von Schump, who may yet become a most important figure. He's the place kicker, and they're well within his range right now. But they're not thinking three, they're thinking more. As a matter of fact, Barry Switzer may not choose to go for the tie, even this late in the game. The pitch is outside to Sims. He runs through a tackle. He's down to the 5-yard line. He fumbles. Nebraska's got the ball. Jim Pillen has the ball. Ten fumbles for the Sooners. They've lost it 6 times. They had the ball first and goal to go inside the 5 as he was hit and went down. Sims puffed it up, and little Jim Pillen was right there.
Let me tell you, Sims was hit on there. He didn't just drop it. There was a collision. But watch the execution by Lott. You wonder why. You don't have to wonder. The Switzer says he's the very best. But then Fisher misses it. You can see those strong legs we talked about. But the ball
Hansen
comes out. Give credit to Nebraska's defense.
Hansen hit it. At the 3, it is Nebraska. Out of the end zone comes Rick Burns. And Burns runs it out across the 15-yard line for a first down. And 3 minutes and 20 seconds to play in the game.
Every play
maybe a national championship riding on every play right now.
What a big run that was out of the end zone.
A pitch sweep.
The ball is at the 17. First down. Burns again over the top. He's outside the 20 to the 21. We're inside 3 minutes to play in the game. 17-14 Nebraska. Jimmy Pillen, who has just been super today.
Boy, he's all Big 8 last year. He's very fine player. Watch Nebraska. Slow their pace down. Take all the time you can, but don't get a penalty.
Burns now has 103 yards in the ball game for Nebraska. Burns again. Comes back this way. Great run by Burns. Sorely, the quarterback realized that Rick had changed directions, and he stuck his helmet right in there and laid out a block. Watch it.
Watch Burns reverse his field. Sorely, number 12, the quarterback, is going to throw the biggest block of his life right there on Jimerson.
The gain is out to the 31-yard line, and it's another Nebraska first down with two and counting to play. Franklin, the fullback, tripped up by Reggie Mathis, defensive end for the Sooners.
The Sooners had jumped into a gap eight. Inside play had no room, and he tried to improvise and go outside, but nothing was there.
A minute and 40 to play in the ball game.
Oklahoma has one timeout, Keith.
Nebraska being as deliberate as possible. The back judge has got a little timer on his arm when it buzzes. It'll cost you five. Second down, nine. Give it to Rick Burns one more time, and Burns cuts it back inside and gets a couple of yards before Phil Tabor brings him down. 113 yards on 25 carries for Burns.
Keith, they dropped the flag on a personal foul on either number 17 of Oklahoma or right in the backfield. The referee dropped the flag. I don't know who it's on. Yes, it's on Oklahoma.
So they're going to walk off 15 against the Sooners.
And taking number 17 ejected from the game.
Barry goes out, puts his arm around the young man. This is an emotional rivalry. You can understand. My frustration, that anxiety would enter into it.
That was after the play, Keith. They were just shoving each other, and then something happened. Here it is on the replay. Now watch number 17 from the right part of the screen. He is, I don't know what he's doing, but
must have happened
probably
after
happened
that.
After that.
Yeah. Well, whatever, the flag has been thrown.
Now, that's where he hits him, right there, yep. With the elbow. Yep. Let the elbow fly right at Nelson, I believe it is.
Jeff Finn, 87, I think it is.
87, yes.
Time is called here for a moment as Sorely has gone to the sidelines to talk to Tom Osborne. Sooners are out of timeouts, according to the scoreboard. Have no more remaining.
They can quarterback sneak the clock out, I believe, Keith. 25 in the huddle, 4 or 5 seconds. They can come close. They can quarterback sneak it out now.
Ball is up at the 47-yard line of Nebraska. Banks, brokenhearted, on the bench. Sorely keeps it. Clock starts to run now. The Sooners have no more timeouts remaining. Coming down out of the stand. Nebraska hasn't beaten Oklahoma since 1971. Oklahoma top ranked in the nation coming in, deservedly so. The clock rolls along at 35. 10 turnovers, 10 fumbles, you lose 6. Yep, that's the big reason right there. 22 seconds and counting. The Huskers taking their time. They don't care about a 5-yard penalty here. If they use too much time, they'll just take it. 10 seconds to play. Tremendous football game. Final play of the ball game. Time is over. And the more than 76,000 people, I think all of them, want to come down on the field as the Nebraska Cornhuskers upset the top-ranked Oklahoma Sooners in a tremendous college football game by a score of 17-14. The offensive and defensive players of the game, each receiving in their name for their university and the university's general scholarship fund from Nebraska. The IVAC, Rick Burns, the offensive player of the game. Jim Pillen, the defensive player of the game. University of Nebraska receiving a total of $2,000 from Chevrolet for their general scholarship fund.
And Keith, there go the goalposts.
Sooners 14. If you're pragmatic at all, you know full well nothing goes on forever. And the Nebraska Cornhuskers break the string against the Oklahoma Sooners as Tom Osborne brought a daring game plan to this ball game and exercised it and finally beat Oklahoma the first time in his career after 6 years at Nebraska that he has defeated an Oklahoma team. Rick Burns, the Chevrolet offensive player of the game. Jim Pillen, the Chevrolet defensive player of the game. The games following, the Prudential College scoreboard, and then we'll have our regional coverage that we've already shown you, including the Alabama-LSU game. The executive producer of NCAA football is Lou Norwich. Today's coverage of the Oklahoma-Nebraska game produced by Chuck Howard, directed by Andy Sedaris. Our technical director, John Allen. Our associate director, Kurt Gowdy. Research, Jerry Klein. Statistician, Mike Swanson. Keith Jackson, along with Frank Broyles and Bill Fleming, saying goodbye from Lincoln, Nebraska. Stay tuned now for Prudential College scoreboard and more NCAA football. Today's game between Oklahoma and Nebraska has been brought to you by Ryder Truck Rentals, the best truck money can rent all East. By Pizza Hut, let yourself go for new Super Style. It's our new pizza that's more cheese, more toppings, more everything. So let yourself go to Pizza Hut. By the incredible Black and Decker and Workmate, there's almost nothing it won't hold. That's why when America has a job to do, it reaches for Black and Decker. And by Goodyear, maker of Tempo, snow tire, rain tire, sun tire, one tire you can drive with confidence all year. Once again, final score, Nebraska 17, Oklahoma 14. Travel arrangements made through. Promotional fee paid by United Airlines.